All right, hello everyone, and peace of Christ to all of you. You know, we as a Christians and Muslims, we have nothing to share. Even they claim that they have someone, his name is Jesus, but they don't even have that name. They don't have Yeshua. They have a person, his name is Isa. And who is Isa? We do not know. So we are talking today with a belief has no source for anything, including the name of the person they are speaking about. You will not find a single book quote someone, his name is Isa. Where this name coming from? We do not know. The Muslim claim that Isa is Jesus, which is Yeshua in Hebrew and Yeshua in Arabic. And how Jesus became the name in the Greek language? Because they don't have equal letters to say the words. Arabic and Hebrew are different. We have more letters than you have in Latin language, which means we have letters you don't have. One of you actually, he asked me to make a comment about the debate which happened between a person, his name Adnan Rashid, which he is a person we invited him many times if he dare to debate me, but he will never do so. We will know that. We know why. But they want to debate only American who don't know anything about Islam, who don't know speak Arabic, and that for a reasons, because they knew if they get close to someone like me, they will be humiliated. Otherwise, give me a reason why they will not do it. This person in his, the same as all Muslims' argument, they don't know the Bible. They copy from websites. They go to website and they print, which make a debate like this very hilarious, because there's no debate. Everyone, he have a print, the Christian guy and the Muslim guy. They have a print in the front of them and they are reading for you from the print. What about you post the print and there's no need for debate? Where is the debate? There's no debate. But today I will give you an example how those kind of silly, I call them silly debates, because you see, if there is no opportunity for each other to corner each other, then there is no debate, right? There's no debate. Before we start, I'm not going to play all his videos, but I will give you a summary, because all of those claims we answer many million times, but the Muslim, they repeat them today, tomorrow, next week, doesn't matter. I answer now. After 5 minutes, a Muslim will ask me questions no Christians can answer, right? So I'm going to show you how silly the claim of the Muhammadan.
He was crucified. Did the thieves scorn him for being crucified and say that his Lord had abandoned him and left him to his enemies? Or did only one of them scorn him? And did the other rebuke the one who scorned him? Both thieves mocked Jesus. Or did one defend him? These variations you can see in the Gospel of Mark is one thing. The Gospel of Luke, we have another. Conjecture, keep conjecture in mind. I am substantiating the Quranic view on this. The Quran simply makes a claim that Christians are following conjecture. And we will see why. At what hour did this crucifixion take place? Was it in the third hour, or as Mark says, or in the sixth, as John says? What happened after the so-called crucifixion? Mark says that the veil of the temple was torn from top to bottom. Matthew adds that the earth shook and rocks crumbled, and many of the saints rose from their graves and entered the holy city, appearing to many. Luke says that the sun turned dark and the veil of the temple was torn in the middle. And when the centurion saw what had happened, he glorified God and said, truly this man was righteous. But John does not know anything about these things. John has nothing to say on these things.
Okay, we will stop here. Here you will see that the Muslim strategy is to make you feel or think, okay, the Bible are not giving the same stories. First of all, I say that to all the Abdul in the world. We have four books, not four copy-paste. And this is why everyone is mentioning details, less or more. Why John want to repeat what is exactly written in Mark? that will be exactly the same copy paste, and then he do not need to write the story, it's already there. So this is how silly this argument. Those are four books, and the four books are completing each other. Otherwise, we do not need four books. We will have only one. Are we listening, Christians? If every one of them is going to say exactly as what it was in the other book, then there is no need for books. Why we call it the book of John, and why we call it the book of Mark, and why we call it, just we call it the Bible, and that's it. Those are four books, not four copy paste. So this is how silly. Why John need to repeat? John, he did not know about it. Who told you that John do not know about it? Is that the interpretation of Ibn Kathir, or this is the interpretation of Mama? And then he says,
even though John came later.
Jane came later, you see? There's no way John did not read what is already written before him. Even Joe came later. I mean, you just answer yourself. This is how silly you are. So what do you want John to write exactly what is written in Mark? That will make him just copy paste. There's no need to write. We do not need writing again and again. Four books can complete each other. What else, Abdul?
Now these problems, very important issues. Did Jesus die before the curtain of the temple was torn? Yes, Matthew says and Mark says, as you can see the references there. But no, after the curtain was torn, then Jesus, crying with a loud voice, said, Father, into thy hands I commit my spirit. And having said this, he breathed his last. Luke. Where was Jesus at the sixth hour on the day of the crucifixion? On the cross, Mark tells us, 15:23. And John 19:14 tells us, in Pilate's court.
This is how what happened when you debate with someone is an idiot. You see, when you say you claim that you are a scholar is not someone who go in the stage and read a paper, otherwise people will laugh at you. The two books are very accurate, because the sixth hour, one is speaking to the Roman using the Roman time. In the sixth hour, Jesus was in front of the court. That the 6 hours of the Roman calendar. The Jewish time is different. Idiot. So one book is speaking to the Jews, the other book is speaking to the Roman. If you say to the Roman the 6 hours, they will be confused. They will think it is different time, unless you make it clear that this is your time. So he is speaking to the Roman using their time. So the 6 hour, the Roman time started at middle of the night, you idiot, which we are using now. The Jewish time is different. The Jewish time starts by sunrise and end by sunset. This is why, because in the book of Genesis it says that God, he created light and he called it day, and he created, you know, in the night he called it the dark, he called it night. But this is what happened when a kid, he wear a suit and he tried to explain to you your book. Which hour was Jesus on the cross? Well, in the sixth hour, in the book of John 19:14, he was in the court. John is speaking to the Roman, Abdul. The 6 hour of the Roman time, which means he was there in the morning. This is not what you are talking about. So they try to fool you using their foolishness that there is a contradiction. You know what? I'm going to use the same method of this guy. I will play a little bit before we start getting them busted, because we did not start yet.
Right. Did Jesus ascend to paradise the same day of the crucifixion? Yes, according to Luke 23:43.
Anyway, he will keep going. I do not need to go all over it. And the funny in the video too, he says, Christians, I see Christians, they hold the Bible in their hand, but they have no witnesses. I mean, this is the most stupidest statement ever. So you have a man, his name is Muhammad. He never witnessed Jesus. He never spoke to Jesus. He is not from the Jews. He never been in the city of Jesus. And yet he have no witnesses, yet he will tell you what happened to Jesus. Do you see the hypocrisy? Do you see the stupidity? He says that what is the proof that the Bible of the Christian is true? We have thousands of manuscript, ancient manuscript. You have none. The Muslims, few years ago, a Christian priest, he gave a gift to the museum, in, I think to Stanford University. And it was dated to the 70, like the, almost at the time of Muhammad or even before. But this is, was the date of the letter. The Muslims, they are a big party. It is one page and it's not even the same as the Quran today. You have nothing. The Quran you have today, you Muslims agree that this is called Mushaf Uthman. Where is the book of Uthman? You don't have it. So what do you have? If we open Mushaf Uthman, it says that this book is according to the recitation of starting from Hafs, who is accused by Muslim to be a fraud. And this is why all his hadith is not accepted. So all the Quran you have today is coming from recitation, not a written book, of a guy, his name is Hafs, who was exist more than 200 years after Muhammad. The same as your hadith. Who is al-Bukhari? Who is Sahih Muslim? Who is at-Tirmidhi? When they start collecting the hadith, they never witnessed Muhammad, they never been with Muhammad, they never saw Muhammad, yet the Muslims have no problem. The same as the Quran. They accept recitation. Now, I said that those Bibles, they are giving us more or less details. Depend in, they don't want to repeat it's you know, each other. For the art, for books, not for copy paste. If we same, if we ask the same Abdul to use his logic, he's asking why it says here, there, and why it says that. Okay, I'm going to go and use your logic. Chapter 56, verse number 13 and 14. What it says? That there is people will go to heaven, the garden of Allah. A multitude of those of old and few of those of later time. Okay, so what the problem? In different verse, Allah says the opposite. This is about judgment day. This is not different for different writers. This is the same person. His name supposedly is Allah. Chapter 56. By the way, we are reading the same what? The same chapter. The same chapter have a huge contradiction. One saying that few of those later time, they will enter heaven. And many of those old time, they will enter heaven. I think the verse is so clear. In the same chapter, verse number 40, it says, a multitude of the old and multitude of those later. But you just said a few in those later, they will enter heaven. Do you see it? Is that more details? No, this is a contradiction. Is that less details? No, this is total contradiction, because all what Allah is supposedly saying, you know what? From the old days, there is people who will enter and they will be huge in number. Like the time of Abraham, the time of Moses, there will be a lot of people will enter from heaven from that time. And then a few from those later time, they will enter. I mean, the verse is so clear, you do not need even, you know, what happened? How the same chapter saying the opposite? So the Muslim, when he say, how come? Well, we can answer your come is very easy, and we can show you that you are being a foolish, but you cannot answer how come in this. Can you? Let me open my Skype so maybe we can hear some how come from the Muhammadan. I like their how come. Is Allah sure how many they will enter heaven? In the judgment day time, many from the old time and few from the old time, or many from the old time and many from the new time. Do we have any Muslim want to say anything? May they? Any Muslim? Somebody, he sent me a question in Skype. He's saying, there is many people before Muhammad, they call Muhammad. So, and Muhammad is not the first one. My friend, if the pagan, they use the name Muhammad, Muhammad, he have no excuse to use such a name, for this is a name for God, the praised one. You ask any Muslim what the praised one mean, they will say to you, I mean, what Muhammad mean, they will say the praised one. Okay, let us say there's people before me, or my neighbor, he used such a name, as you claim. Is that an excuse for me to call myself the praised one too? Yet I claim that I am a person who believe in one God. That is very silly argument. And you know, if you have a question, you know, feel free, you can post it for us and we will answer you. There were many call Muhammad. Who care about this? I mean, some people, they have a very low IQ. There's many people called Muhammad. Oh, by the way, there's many people called Yeshua too. So what? But there's no one is called the Christ. But Muhammad is choosing a name. This is not his name. And we prove it many times. Isn't it the Quran says that Isa, he said, there's a prophet will come after me. His name is Ahmad. So if Muhammad is the name, which is, this is what his father called him with, then he should not say Ahmad, he should say Muhammad. Ahmad is a close name as meaning, but it's not the same name. It's written totally different, pronounced differently. So what is the close between them, the meaning? That because he don't have a name. Muhammad claiming that he is the praised one. Very silly talk. Same time, if Muhammad's name mean the praised one or mean the praised for, that will not change that Muhammad cannot be Muhammad, for he is a person who have a bad ethic. He's a thief. He's a criminal. Even his followers, they accuse him of stealing an underwear. And we can go that for that later. Remind me. We have many hadith about, I mean, many times we made videos about that. You can watch them. So how he became be called Muhammad? Unless Muhammad was claiming to be Jesus, maybe claiming that he is God on earth. Actually, this funny guy who was talking about Jesus, when the two women, they came to see Jesus, the women, they bow down and they worship him. And yet the Abdul, he says to you, where Jesus says, I am God, worship me. show me. Even in his debate, but he have to read the verse, so he had no choice. So how many they will go to heaven in the later time? Few or many? This is not a different information. This is a total contradiction. How many days Allah took him to create the earth? There's many chapters in the Quran, it says 6 days. Okay. But there's other chapters in the Quran says there are 8 days. The Muslim, he will say, no. In the other chapter, it just there's more details. You see the hypocrisy? Do you see the hypocrisy? He will not accept, you know, he will not accept our explanation, which is our belief. He suddenly he accept his own explanation, even though the Quran never say that. And even his prophet never said that. If we go in the Quran, we will find this. How many days Allah took him to create the earth? Hold on. Say, O Muhammad, into the adulterers, disbelieve, verily, blah, 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 Allah, him who created the earth in 2 days. How many days? 2 days. Create what? The earth. But this is just the shape of the earth. He placed therein firm hill, rising above it, and he blessed it, and measured therein the substance in 4 days. Isn't it clear? 2 days to create the earth, 4 days to create what is in the top of the earth. And then he turned to the heaven, and it was a smoke. And he finished that in the heaven, his work, in 2 days. What the total? 8 days. So what is the verse about 6 days then? Is that more details? No, that will be stupid. The verse is so clear, saying that Allah, he created the earth in 2 days. The earth creation is done. And then he, after he created the earth, he start working what? In the mountains, which is very stupid to say. He placed their infirm hills. The Quran teaches that the earth was without mountain. Allah, he put mountains in the top of it. Why? So the earth will not shake on you. And he create all the substance of the earth, like water, grass, trees, in 4 days. It's so clear. The Muslim, to avoid this disaster, they say to you, no, no, no. Here the 4 days is containing those 2 days. Hold on. How it's containing those 2 days? If Allah says he created the earth in 2 days, that's mean he want to tell us that this is what it took me to create the earth. Do you see here about earth creation? No. Here start taking out to us, telling us what he did after he created the earth in 2 days. What he did? He placed therein firm hills rising above it, and he blessed it, and he made the grass and the trees. It's very clear. And the heaven was a smoke, which means there was nothing. And then he did the heaven, 7 heavens in 2 days. The total is 8. However, Muhammad is the same as this guy in this video. He is suffering from multiple personality. He don't remember what he said yesterday. He says something in the morning, he says something else afternoon. If we go now and we see what Muhammad said. Is that Muhammad talking, or this is Zakir Naik? So you can tell me I don't agree with Zakir Naik. Is that Muhammad talking, or this is Ibn Abbas? Is that Muhammad talking, or this is the guy who do drive always when you call me? This is your prophet. The one which the Quran says that nothing Muhammad he say except it is inspiration from Allah, which even his normal talk is from Allah. Muhammad said, not me. Allah, and this is Sahih Muslim, by the way. Muslim cannot say this is daif and this is weak and vitamin B and C. My friend, I saw you explain Al-Ma'idah 116. Are you, what's wrong with you? Don't you see we have a topic? That's it. This is the only topic you have in your head for today. Yesterday you posted. Today you are posting it. Even yesterday you are posting since yesterday when I am offline. What's wrong with you? Please, guys, this guy, he need help. Al-Ma'idah 116. What's wrong with you? Can't you wait? Amazing. Don't get married, man. Your wife will divorce you second day if you do that. Allah the Exalted, the Glorious. created the clay on Saturday. Let us count the numbers together, people. Let us count the numbers together and see how smart Muhammad is. When Allah, he created the clay on Saturday. Do we agree? Does it say Saturday or I'm fabricating things? It says Saturday. Okay, this is the number one. I'm typing in Arabic, hold on. So this is day number two. Okay, and he created the mountains in on Sunday. This is day number two, right? And he created the trees on Monday. Okay, this is day number three. And he create things entirely in labor on Tuesday. This is day number four. And he created the light on Wednesday. This is day number five. And he created like animals, etc., on Tuesday. This is day number six. And he created Adam Friday afternoon, Asr. You see the word Asr? At what day? Friday. Day number seven. Who is the stupid here? Who is the stupid? So you are telling me that Mark is giving more details than Luke, and John giving less detail than Mark, which are four writers, and they are not repeating themselves. Each one of them, he is an own, he have his own writing, which is telling us the story based in the language he speak, based on, let us say, to complete what his people need to know, not just to repeat a story. If we are four people witnessing the same thing, the same exact thing, and we ask the four people to write what they saw, you will see each one of them, he writes something. The other one, he did not write. Because everyone is showing you something he is more interested in. And by the help of God, the four, they complete each other, not repeating each other. But here we have a prophet. This is not Mark, this is not John, this is not Luke, this is one person. He cannot repeat what he said in the morning. In the morning he said that Allah created the earth and the heaven in 6 days. Afternoon he said it was 8 days. By night he said there are 7 days. Which one is the correct one? Any Muslim? This is not Mark, this is not Luke, this is not John, this is one person. The Quran come to you through Muhammad, the Hadith come to you through Muhammad, and all of them supposedly is coming from Allah. How Muhammad knew this? Where Muhammad he got that the clay created in Saturday, and the mountain in Sunday, and the trees in Monday? Where he got this from? This from Allah. So how Muhammad, he is saying something stupid here. Allah created Adam a Friday afternoon. And the funny, by the way, the Muslims, they say to you, brother, the Quran never spoke about 6 days like our days. It's six period, brother. Watch the video of Zakanaik. Ibn Antitar. The Quran says that God, Allah created the earth in 6 days. But those are 6 periods of time. They are not day as we know today. Sun in the morning or night, as in the Bible says. Those are 6 periods. What period, you idiot? He says Saturday and Sunday and Monday. And he is saying that Adam was created Friday afternoon. And they claim that those periods are billions of years. Friday afternoon is billions of years. Friday afternoon is 200 billion year in one Muslim website. Do you see how we get you busted? Are we done? We did not speak about Jesus yet. Don't forget, we will not forget about this, because this is what the topic is about. But I'm just showing you how stupid the logic. They don't use their own logic on themselves. They want to use it in ourselves only, in ourselves, on us. Muslim, he will never use his logic to himself. The Muslim will say to you, who is the witness that the book of John, written by John? You have no witness of Jesus at all. You accepted what a guy, he came 600 years after Jesus. Do you see the stupidity? So the question, okay, hold on. There is a problem here, brother. The Bible, the first Bible written between 50 to 60 years after Jesus. Abdul, where you get this information from? This is what the Christian says, okay. And what is the proof? What is the witnesses? Muhammad, he came, so a person who came after Jesus in 50 AD. Yet, it is not acceptable by Abdul. But a person who came 600 years after Jesus. There's a guy, his name is Mimi Hijab. He says, 600 years, this is, so 50 years, this is long time. Long time. 50 years is long time after Jesus. And 600 years of Muhammad after Jesus is a short time. There's one thing all the Muslims, they share. Double standard, hypocrisy, and taqiyya, which is play the play for protecting Islam. Do you accept to apply this standard on you Muslims? That we should not accept anyone to teach about Jesus unless he is from the time of Jesus? Hypocrisy is amazing. And especially when this hypocrisy is armed with stupidity. By the way, do even Allah remember which one he created first? The earth or the heaven? This is my challenge in front of all the Muhammadan. Who is a Muslim willing to call me right now and tell me which one Allah created first? The stars or the trees? Anyone? Hey, hold on. Somebody's posting saying, Saturday to Sunday, Saturday to Sunday, one day. Hey, no, it's not Saturday to Sunday. I mean, you are being smart now. This is very smart of you. This is not Saturday to Sunday. Who told you Saturday to Sunday? Everyone is day by itself. On Saturday, he created the clay. Not Saturday to Sunday is when day. And as you see, just to show you this, how funny what you said, Mr. I don't know how to write your name. When you say from Saturday to Sunday is one day, and from Sunday to Monday, that is not what it says here. It says the following. He created the clay on Saturday. That means all the clay created on Saturday, nothing else. Correct, people? It's not a day continue here, start there, Saturday. And what is Saturday on Islam? Muhammad is using the same timeline as the Jews. The sunset, the sunrise. This is why Allah, he stopped working at the afternoon on Friday. And this is why the Quran, I want people to listen carefully. This is how we get people busted when they try to fabricate. When Allah was creating Adam on a Friday afternoon, anyone remember what Adam he says to Allah? Who remember? Who remember? Let us see how many of you is taking notes. Just to show you what this guy he said from Saturday to Sunday is wrong, regardless if he's a Muslim or not. Who remember what Adam he said to Allah? Hurry, finish me up before the sun set. So Friday by sunset, Allah he stopped. This is why the last thing is created. It is Adam between them afternoon and night. Allah don't work at night. He's blind. And even there is a verse about it in the Quran where Allah said, وَكَانَ الْإِنسَانُ عَجُولًا. What does that mean? Human being was ever like hasty. Chapter 17, verse number 11. You go to the interpretation, you will see that Allah, when he was creating Adam, Adam he sneezed, Allah said to him, God bless you. And then Adam he says to Allah, please finish me before the sunset. And this is not my explanation. This is the Abdul explanation. The scholars, not those who go in the speaker corners, they are wearing two diapers in order to make themselves big. How are you, Abbas? We have a friend here. His name is Abbas. He's a Muslim. Abbas, call us, please. Give me your ID. I will call you in Skype. Now, just because this person who asked me many times, forgive me if I get upset from your post about Al-Ma'idah. But guys, you see, I'm talking about a topic. I mean, can't you wait? I mean, what will happen if we wait? My hands already is busy. Al-Ma'idah 116, Al-Ma'idah 116. Oh, okay, just think. I'm here. I did not go anywhere. Al-Ma'idah 116, additional proof that the one who wrote the Quran is an official idiot. Why? Because Allah asking Jesus, did you say to your followers to worship me and my mother beside Allah? First of all, Jesus don't believe in Allah, and nowhere the name of Allah is written in our Bible. The Muslim, they will say to you, oh, if you go in the Arabic Bible, this is a translation, it's a false translation. The Bible, my friend, is not a translation unless the translation is accurate. So, if the Arabic Bible translation using false words, which is not exist neither in the Greek or the Hebrew or the Aramaic, then this is a false translation. Secondly, who are the Christians who worship Mary as God? Look like Allah is a stupid. He do not know what the Trinity is. This is additional proof that the one who wrote the Quran, he cannot be God, neither he is a person who have little education. If you ask any Muslim today, what is the Trinity? They will say to you, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Okay, who? Where is Mary? Where is Mary in the story? So this is additional proof that the Quran is written by an ignorant. Best translation is the, you see, if somebody gave you a translation, compare it. There is a Jewish manuscript for the Old Testament and even for the New Testament. As an example, there's a translation in the Bible. It's called Aramaic in Plain English, which is very good translation. Why? Because they are taking the Aramaic, not the translation from translation. So you have to find the best translation, examine it, because translator can be a deceiver too. I can make now Jehovah's Witnesses, they have a translation, but their book is false. Correct? Jehovah's Witnesses, they have a book, start with John chapter 1 verse 1, identical to your book as names, but inside translation is false. Now, did we answer you about this verse? This is a stupid verse proving to us that the one who spoke about Jesus, he did not know anything about Jesus. Secondly, why Allah is asking Jesus? The Muslims, just to show you the hypocrisy, the Muslims in the Old Testament, they say, God, he says to Adam, where are you, Adam? The Muslim, they say, God do not know where is Adam? I will use your logic. No, God, he knew where Adam. God saying to Adam, why you are hiding? You know that you are guilty, right? Higher. Do Allah knew what Jesus said? Or he do not know? So why he's asking him? You will give me exactly the same answer I gave you. This is how hypocrite you are. Do we have any Muslim want to call us? Anyone? Now, we are not done. In the Quran, there's many chapters speaking about the creation. We will go back to Jesus, because remember, it's about the crucifixion of Jesus. But this is a book of contradiction. This book has nothing but contradiction. I will give you an example which is going to get all the religion of Islam busted in 2 seconds. Not only Allah do not know which one he created first, the stars or the trees, and I'm waiting for a Muslim to call me and prove me wrong. Allah, he say crazy stuff beyond madness. I'm not going to talk about the sunset in murky water. No. Or about the sperm is coming from the ribs of the women. No. Because, brother, this is proven to be accurate. Okay. Let us see. Somebody is sending me an ID of a Muslim. All right. We have a Muslim. He wants to talk to us. Let us see. Answer me, my friend. I just texted you. The one you call yourself Muhammad. All right. Finally, we got a Muslim. He would like to share with us. That's wonderful. Please, guys, no name calling, no bad language. We will ban you.
Yeah, hello, CP.
How are you, my friend?
Yeah, I'm good.
Turn off your camera, please. I'm not really interested in your camera, if you don't mind.
I don't know how to use this, so wait a second, please.
All right.
Now.
Okay, my friend, what do you want to say to us? Go ahead.
Listen, CP, I have listened to you for a few months, and I want to begin with my English. My English is not so good, so sorry.
My English too. I'm not. English is not my first language. No problem. Don't worry. I understand you.
First of all, I have a friend who is Christian, and he is talking a lot about you. And about 2 years ago, I lost my girlfriend, and I go to mosque. I begin to go to mosque because my family is I'm from Muslim family.
Okay.
So they they said to me, we can be your family and everything. You are like our brother, and in Islam is about love and mercy. And you talking about different stuff on about Islam.
Okay.
Why?
Because it's what Islam is about. I mean, what different stuff? Everything, my friend. Your name is Muhammad. What's your name?
No, Abbas.
Abbas. Mr. Abbas. Anything I say, as you see, and you are saying you are watching me for long, have you ever seen me speaking about something without showing it immediately in the screen? You see it in the screen, right?
Yes, okay. I see
so,
it.
So you cannot say to me why you are saying that. This is what it says. Give me an example why I'm saying that. Like what exactly? So I can understand you better.
Why are the Muslims so good to me, and they take me like their brother? And
are you a Muslim or not? You are a Muslim, right?
Yes, of
okay,
course.
Okay, so they are the brother. The Quran says, وَإِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أُخْوَى. Those who they are believers, they are brothers. So they have to be good to you. However, I never saw a Muslim good to a Muslim. Since when? The Muslims, they killed Uthman ibn Affan. And before they kill him, they took the hair of his beard one by one. The Muslim, they killed Umar ibn al-Khattab. The Muslim killed all the caliphate. The Muslim, they killed the grandsons of the Prophet. So you are lucky, my friend, that those your friends are good to you. I don't know why. Maybe they want something. But I never saw a Muslim is good for a Muslim.
Actually, they want me to join to ISIS for a few months ago.
Here we go. They are trying to recruit you. This is why they are trying to make you join ISIS. So you die for the sake of, the Prince of Qatar.
Yeah, they tell me about you know, I don't know so much about Islam, but I'm like I said, I'm from a Muslim family, and I have never been in so religious, but now I'm little confused because I have a friend from South America, and he from Chile, and he tell me a lot of Christianity. And I don't know, like I said, I'm a little confused.
Okay, so now what do you want? What do you, how I can help you?
My English is so bad, so I don't know.
Okay, my friend, you are wasting my time. Your English is so bad. Let's go back to our topic. You want to leave Islam, leave Islam. You want to stay as a Muslim, stay as a Muslim. Don't waste my time. The Quran says the following. Who says that? The Quran. And we never sent a messenger save with the language of his folk, that they might make it clear for them. This is a good logic, actually. So the Quran confirmed to us, not this guy in the video here who do not know what he's talking about. The Quran says Allah never sent a messenger. What messenger we are talking about? A Muslim messenger. Unless what? Unless he speak the tongue of his people, which means there's two conditions. He have to be from the people, and he speak their tongue. So Muhammad was a messenger to who? I mean, have you ever heard of a stupid teaching more than this? If Allah never sent a messenger unless he speak the tongue and he is from the people, so why Allah send Musa to Pharaoh? And why Isa, he says to the Jews, there's a prophet will come after me, his name is Ahmad. Is Ahmad speaking Hebrew? Is he from the Hebrew? Isn't it the Quran in front of me saying, I never send a messenger in the time of Muhammad, not after Muhammad? Because remember, the one who said this verse is Muhammad himself. My friend, if somebody want to leave Islam, he can leave Islam. Many people leave Islam, they do not need to call me live on air and say I want to leave Islam. No problem. I'm not here to make a short time. I give people time to express themselves, and he is not doing a good job. So if you want to leave Islam, you leave Islam. You want to accept Jesus, welcome. You do not need Christian prince. I'm not here to get the glory of people leaving Islam in my live broadcast. I'm not really too much interested. I have thousands and thousands of people leave Islam and they never speak or spoke to me, not even once. They watch my videos. So if he's convinced already that he want to leave Islam, leave Islam. If you have a question for me, post it in the text. But don't give me every 2 seconds saying to me my English is not good. So what kind of conversation we will have? Now, how Muhammad can be a prophet to tell you about Jesus, yet he don't speak the language of Jesus, he was not exist in the time of Jesus, he is not from the Jews, and he is 600 years after Jesus? Any Abdul? I thought, you know, I get excited because Abdul called me. I thought somebody want to debate me. I don't want someone to call me to say I'm leaving Islam. It makes me happy to see people leaving Islam, but I do not need you to call me and do that. Leave Islam, my friend. Good for you. You leave Islam for your good. You leave. You join Islam. This is your problem. I feel sorry for you. So who's going to answer? This is your Quran, not my words. Allah never sent a messenger to any nation unless he is from the nation speaking the language of the nation. Why? So they might understand the message. Makes sense. So don't give me a Quran in Arabic and someone like Zakir. Do you know that Didad don't speak Arabic? He don't. I made a video about it where Didad says, I don't speak Arabic. He was saying, once a translator was translating for me from Arabic, to English. I told him, I sense that you are not saying correctly what I'm saying, even though I don't speak Arabic. Did that? He said that. Zakir Naik don't speak Arabic. So how those people, they want to explain the Quran to you? The Quran says, I send them messengers to speak their language to make it clear for them. And he have to be from the folk, which means the language is not even second language. Like me, I cannot be a messenger to the American, for I don't speak really a good English. I can be a messenger for the Arab, for I am an Arab. A Muslim is saying, a Christian prince, he need money. My friend, I am not like your prophet. Let me show you what your prophet said. Your prophet was begging for loan, claiming that the one who give Allah a loan, Allah will forgive his sin. Have you ever heard the Christian prince saying, hey guys, give me a loan, and if you give me a loan, I will forgive your sin? And who is the one who will collect the loan? A guy, his name is Muhammad. And what he will do with it? He will buy zucchinis to his wives. Have you ever heard of a God saying, if you lend into Allah a goodly loan, He will double it for you and forgive you. So a Muslim, he tried to speak against me, supposed saying, Christian prince, you need money. Everybody need money. Why not? Who told you I'm a rich guy? I'm not. And who pay for my gas? So what's wrong with me? Need money. I go to the gas station. I tell them I'm Christian prince. They're good to me for free. But here we are talking about a God. His name is Allah. Allah, he need a loan. Can't Allah make the gold come from the ground to Muhammad? Can't Allah, the Muslim, they say to us, Allah, if you want something, he say B is going to be. This guy is begging for money. Who is the bigger? Who is the bigger here? Is Allah. Money, if you lend into Allah, goodly loan. We have Mimi Hijab. He went in the video after the video of David Wood. He quote exactly the same verse. And he recited, when the Quridullah, an ugly voice begging for money, asking Muslims to send donation. He finished the debate. He said, oh, this debate have a good impact between the Muslim, because we fooled them. We made fun of Allah. We made fun of Muhammad. And yet the Muslim think that he made a victory. It's you Muslims who do that, not me. Now, who's a Muslim want to answer us? Who is a beautiful Muslim want to answer us? And the reason I say beautiful, because the Prophet, he said that if a Muslim woman, she take hair from her face, Allah curse her. But he taught the Muslim to take hair from their face. So we have an awkward Prophet. He teach women, if you take hair from your face, he want the women to have a beard. If you take the hair from your face, Allah will curse you. While he says to the Muslim, and he himself, he used to do an nawra. You know what an nawra? Sugar. Imagine. He used to do sugar. So he forbid women from taking hair from their face, yet the Muhammad himself, he do an nawra. And not only that, Muhammad, he promised the Muslims when they go to heaven, they will be hair free, and they will be having eyeliner. What do you mean? Yes, brother. Do you see it? Have you ever heard of such a stupid paradise? Why are you taking chemo from cancer? Why you will lose all your hair? And you will stay for eternity without hair. Any Muslim? Now, so the Quran is full of contradictions and stupid teaching. The hadith is crazy. Muhammad is a crazy man. Muhammad, he suffered from mental disease, and we can go back to that later. But let us go to the crucifixion of Jesus. Quran, when he speak about Jesus, tell us strange stories. As an example, the Muslim, they will say to you, did one angel speak to Mary or many angels? What? Did one angel spoke to Mary when he have the good news, or many angels? One angel. But the Bible says in different verse, many angels. So which one is correct? And the Muslim, he will make it a story. How one verse says angels spoke to Mary, and one verse says an angel spoke to Mary. Which one? Just to show you the hypocrisy. The Bible is telling us the kind of the conversation. The Quran reporting exactly the same story and making the same statement. But the Muslims cannot see what is in the Quran, they can see only what is in the Bible. So when you quote for you the question from the Bible, they say this is a contradiction. But when you show it to them from the Quran, what they will say? How many people, how many angels they spoke to Mary? One? Is it one angel or many? Is it a man or an angel? The verse here in chapter 19, verse 17 says one, and he came to her as a man, not an angel. And actually, he is a spirit of Allah, became in the likeness of a man. In the front verse in the Quran, it says, and when the angels say to Mary. So if we ask the Muslim, is that a contradiction? They say, no, the details is more here. See the hypocrisy, the double standard? Now, if we go to the story of Jesus in the cross, which is the topic for today, how you Christians can get the Muhammadan busted, not only debating them. I don't debate Muslims. I destroy Islam. All the Muslims, they focus in one thing. Jesus was not crucified. But look what the Quran is saying. And I want the Christians to focus with me carefully. Chapter 4, verse 157 in the yellow pages of Islam. It says, and because of their saying, we slew the Messiah, the son of Mary, Allah messenger. Anyone notice here how many mistakes in this? Anyone notice with me how many mistakes is just in this line before we continue? I will give you time to think about it. We will go back. They slew him not, nor crucified him, but it appeared so unto them. Okay, here I need your help. Them who? Anyone can help me? When the Quran says, appeared unto them. Them who? Who want to give me the answer? It appeared unto them. The Jews. Who? The Jews. So it appeared to the Jews that it was the Messiah. And who is the one saying we slew him? Again, the Jews. All right. So we have a continuous claim. Since 600 years ago, according to the Quran, by the Jews saying we slew him. Correct? Why the Jews are lying then? If the Jews did not kill Jesus, why for 600 years they are saying we killed Jesus? Any Muslim can tell us? I mean, what the benefit of that? Do you know how dangerous this claim is? The Roman is the superior empire. And if the Jews are proud about killing Jesus, in the time where the Roman are Christians, that is a very big claim. And why the Jews, they want to say such a thing? Look what the Quran said. They crucified him not. They slew him not, nor crucified him, but it appeared so into them. Look what Muhammad did. Muhammad, he made all of Islam shish kebab right now. Because what the Muslim, they say to us that Jesus was not crucified. And they are trying to prove to us in their debates that what is written in the Bible is false. This is the whole argument of this guy. In the book of Mark, it says this. In the book of John, it says this. And he tried to make you have a conclusion that they have different information when the fact they don't. There are four different books reporting either less or more information depending on the order of the book. So John, who came after, he don't need to repeat things which is mentioned already, unless he have to. So when the Muslim, they say to us, what is written in the Bible is not a proof that Jesus is or being crucified. They just expose their God. Because the God of Islam, not me, not you, the God of Islam is the one who said, they crucified him not, but it was made to appear to them. And you can change the translation if you want. Question to Muslims. When the Quran says, but it appeared into them. Who are they them? Right away we'll say whoever was there. That's mean the disciple of Jesus, Allah, he made Jesus in the cross for them. So what is written in the Bible is absolutely what they witness. Which mean they are telling what they saw. Which mean they are telling the truth, because the truth is to say what you saw, not what you guess. Is that correct, people? Do you understand? If I was in a place and a crime happened, and you ask me, hey, Christian Prince, I want you honestly to tell me what happened. And then I say, oh, there's a guy, or there's a man, or there's a gentleman, his name is John. And John, he was captured by a bunch of people and they crucify him. You ask me, you saw him by your eyes? I say yes. Do you witness for that? I say yes. Am I a liar, guys? Am I lying? No, this is what I saw. So look what happened. The Quran confirmed that this is what they saw. And my friend, who in the world wanna say such a stupid thing that we should not accept what they saw? We should accept what we heard from one guy who came 600 years after Muhammad. Do you understand, people? Do you understand me? What Muhammad is trying to say to us, that all the witness, they are telling the truth. Yes, they saw Jesus, the brother, in the cross. It was Jesus. Even his mother was there. Imagine, his mother, she did not recognize that it's not him. That's what the Muslims are saying to us, that Allah, he cloned someone look exactly like Jesus. So you idiot, you just told me that someone look exactly like Jesus. Where is the proof that this is not Jesus? You just confirmed to me that the one was on the cross, he is Jesus. He have the face of Jesus, the hair of Jesus, the eyes of Jesus, the voice of Jesus. It's confirmed that to us. So how stupid this claim is. You confirm to us that the story written in the Bible is absolutely true. They wrote what they saw. They saw what? They saw Jesus in the cross. The Quran confirmed that. Do you see how easy to destroy such a stupid claim? Because even the Quran, the yellow pages of Muhammad, confirmed that the crucifixion of Jesus happened. All what the Quran is saying, that Allah, he made someone look like Jesus. Who is going to believe in such a garbage? Based on this, we cannot trust anything in Islam. Because a Christian prince might not be Christian prince. Muhammad might be not Muhammad. Shaitan might be not Shaitan. Angel might be not angel. For Allah is not a trustworthy, he play games. Do you understand me? Who is a Muslim is willing to call us and tell us why Allah he cloned someone like Jesus? Anyone? Any Abdul? If the Muslim they will say to save Jesus, how we can get this one busted? Who wanna help me? Let us see how many of you have a very fast processor. If a Muslim says, well, the reason Allah he cloned Jesus is to save him, what we shall say? Thank you, my friend Rational from Indonesia. With my love to all people from Indonesia, the translation of my book in Indonesian language soon will be out. Just give me, have patience with me, please, and we will give it to you for free. Quran and Science. And when the other book is ready, I will publish it too. By the way, for those who do not know, my book, Sex and Allah in German, is already out in Amazon for those who like to have it. Sex and Allah in German. And in the German Amazon and German like German.de and Amazon.de and Amazon.com, they have my book Sex and Allah in German language. And if you live in Germany, it's better to order it from Amazon Germany, because that will give you, I think, free shipping. So just take a note. Now, who wanna help me in this story here? If the Muslim they say Allah he cloned Jesus so he will not be crucified to save him, what we can say? Who want to help me in that? Come on, I'm slow. I'm not really, I do not know what to say. How I can answer a Muslim about this? Anyone? Our friend here, he said this. Shall we show this to the Muslims? No, not him. Hold on. See the sticks in front of me fly. Where is the text? I was going to show. Allah is a liar. Okay, well, we got that. But how we can answer the Muslim now? A Muslim says to you, Allah he cloned someone look like Jesus, so he will not be crucified. Allah simply saving Jesus. So what we can say? Who wanna help me? Why Allah, this is what our friend here, the Psalm says, why clone him when he can save him? That's a good, that's a very good argument, but we can do better. We can do a lot better, but this is a good question. Yes, why Allah need to save, clone him, deceiving us? Don't Allah, he knew that by doing that, he is going to deceive 3 billion Christians? Thank you. Finally, one of you, he said the good answer. How come Allah did not save Muhammad? How Muhammad die, guys? How Muhammad die? Muhammad die by the Jews. Okay, Christ was killed according to the Quran by the Jews, or they tried to kill him, right? Okay. Muhammad died by who? By the Jews. The Jews killed him. Who's confirming that? Is that a witness who came 600 years after Muhammad? No, this is Muhammad, supposedly. They killed him by poison. Okay. So how come Allah, he did not clone at least the stomach of Muhammad? Don't clone Muhammad, please. We don't need two. One is enough. One disaster is enough. Allah could not clone even a stomach for Muhammad. Here you will see how Islam is destroyed and collapsed immediately. Allah saved Jesus. Obviously, Jesus is very valuable for Allah. Muhammad is something you can replace. I mean, who is Muhammad? No one. And the funny, the Muslim, they say to us that Allah, the most beloved person to Allah is Muhammad. And even Allah, he wrote the name of Muhammad in his chair. I cannot wait to see a Muhammad. Allah, I wish I have a video camera when Allah was writing the name. Allah is bending over in his chair. He's writing, "Ashhadu la ilaha illallah Muhammadun Rasulullah." Allah is doing that. Allah is writing the name of Muhammad. I mean, you Muslims are really going so far with the madness. So Allah is Almighty God, yet He is writing the name of Muhammad. Who is Muhammad? It's like somebody created a mosquito and he want to write the name of mosquito in his chair. Look like your God Allah is a silly kid. Hey kid, hikiti kitty kitty. I gave you a mosquito today. Do you know what I will name the mosquito? What? Charlie. Charlie Chaplin. And then this kiddie, he go and he write in his chair, "I witness that there is no Charlie except Charlie Chaplin." What is that? Allah, he let his prophet Muhammad die. And the poison is cutting his artery. And hold on. That will be connected to the Quran because we are not done. What the Quran says, who remember? Anyone remember? Muhammad, he said in the Quran, "If I fabricated Quran, if I fabricated words claiming to be from God," who is the one is talking? Allah, supposedly. "If he invented any false saying concerning us," Allah speaking, "we assuredly had taken him by the right hand and then severed his life artery." Do you see it? The foolish Muhammad, he said long ago, he never heard, he never thought later he will have the same, he will die in such a way. Exactly as he said, if he is lying, if he's fabricating Quran, Allah will cut his artery. Do you see it? Even the death of Muhammad proving Muhammad to be false. So look what happened here. The story of Muhammad's death proved that Muhammad is a false prophet by his own words. Not Christians, not the Jews, not the Hindus, not the Buddhas, not Moody, not a Trump. Muhammad, he said, "If I am a person who did that, Allah will cut my order." And this is exactly how he died. Is that a weak hadith? No. Is that a da'if hadith? Is that a shish? This is Sahih al-Bukhari. This is the second book of the Quran. And this hadith is in a total agreement with the Quran. Somebody might say, "So are you saying that Allah, he punished Muhammad?" No. There's no Allah. Muhammad is Allah. But the liar Muhammad, he fabricated those verses because he never thought he would die in such a way. He forgot what he said. But our Lord, he wanted to prove to you Christians that this guy is a liar and he will die as he wished. Do you understand? Our sister here is saying, "Hi CP, Indonesian Muslim channel said that Allah saved Jesus and allow Muhammad to die. Is that the job of Muhammad on earth is finished, so Allah allow him to die?" You see, first of all, he did not die. The word "die" is not accurate. He was killed. And if Allah, did Allah save Jesus because Jesus, he did not finish his job? Well, can't he resurrect him anyway? You see, in Christianity, Jesus, he did not finish his job yet too. He's coming back, isn't he? So death will not prevent God to let someone complete his mission. He can resurrect him. Secondly, when the Muslim, they said that to you, that Muhammad, he don't have any job and Jesus have, who is more important than? So how Muslim, they say that Muhammad is the most important person for Allah. If the one who will kill the devil is Jesus, the one who will fulfill the peace in earth is Jesus, the one who will rule the earth is Jesus, the one who in his time people do not need money is Jesus, and the one who will be hakaman muqsitan, which means an absolute just and justice, is Jesus. So what was the job of Muhammad? Nothing. Spreading terrorism, people killing people. What happened since Muhammad came to the earth? Slaughtering people, slaughtering each other. And Muhammad, he told them, oh, hold on. When you kill somebody, just to make them not to feel guilty, it's not you who killed them, it's Allah. It's not you who slew him, it's Allah. It's not even you who shoot. If you shoot a person in Islam, the Muslim, when they shoot somebody or they kill somebody or they will cut the head of somebody, they recite this verse. It's not you who slew them, it's Allah. Who is talking Allah? Okay. That's mean Muslims have no jobs. It's Allah who slew people. It's appearance, it's fake. You think you are slew him, but it's not you who slew him, it's Allah. So the Muslim claim that Allah, he did not save Muhammad, that is a stupid claim. Especially if this death confirming that Muhammad is a thief and he is a fraud. Because this is exactly what Allah, he said he will do to Muhammad if he did fabricate Quran. So this is not only about saving Jesus or saving Muhammad. This is about why Muhammad, he died in such a way. And if the reason for Jesus to be saved is because he's coming back, still you can save him after he's been crucified, and that will be an amazing miracle of Allah. Do we have any Muslim want to say anything? The funny, the Muslim, they say how God, God the Father, he allowed Jesus, his son, to suffer. Do you know what Muhammad is saying here? This was not a 3 or 4 or 6 hours of suffering. This is a very slow, ugly, painful death. According to Muslims, it took him 4 years. 4 years of his life, he vomit, he can't sleep, he scream, he's dying. And the funny, the Muslim, they will say, well, you know, it doesn't say Orta here. No, it says Orta. Abhari. We can take the word right now to the dictionary. Abhar and Alwatin is the same word. We can go right now to the dictionary and I can show it to you live. Especially if a Muslim, he called me and they challenged me to prove it. Who want to do that? By the way, what is the last thing Muhammad, he did before he died? And what is the last thing Jesus, he did before he died in the cross? Anyone remember? What is the last thing Muhammad did before he died? Muhammad, he pissed. Have you ever heard of a prophet like this? And what Jesus, what is the last thing Jesus did before he died? Any Muslim want to tell us something? Muslims, what is the last act of Jesus and the last act of Muhammad. How we can compare between this and that? The last thing Muhammad he said before, or he did before he died, sorry, not said, he pissed. Why Allah did not tell him, you are going to die soon, go and pray something, say a few words, say shahada. Don't you Muslims have to say shahada before you die? So while Jesus in the cross is speaking to the Father, as the last few words he spoke before he died on the cross, Muhammad was asking to pee. He pissed and he died. Anyone have the hadith? Anyone have the hadith for that? Who remember the hadith? If anyone have it, post it, please, instead of me looking for it. And this is additional proof that Muhammad is a false prophet. I mean, you are a prophet of God. The last moment, you obviously Muhammad do not know he is going to die. Otherwise, it's not going to be the last thing I want to do is to piss. You know what I mean? This is stupid. If we go in the hadith, actually our one of the good admins, he posted the hadith already. We are not making things up. The last thing Muhammad he did, he pissed. He did not say Allah. He did not say, I love you all. You know, coming, oh, you are dying. What piss? I want to try that before I die. The last moment before I die, I want to go to the bathroom. And I'm going to sing, this is how we do it. And I will claim to be a prophet. So we have mountains of evidence that Muhammad is a false prophet. Why don't die? What's wrong with death? My friend, death is a mercy for mankind. It's not really something bad. Imagine you live forever and in this filthy earth, and then you know, like you get sick and you get older, and people suffer trying to serve you. I mean, why you want to do that? Death is mercy. It is mercy. However, the Lord, he said, "Whoever believe in me and die will live." So this is just a new journey. Your death is just a new journey. For us, the death of a believer is not the end. So why you want to fear death? Never fear death. Actually, those who fear death, death chase them. If I tell you stories of my life, you will not believe it. I should be dead from long, long time. Do we have any Muslim would like to say something to us about his prophet? So as you see, the story in the Quran confirmed that the story in the Bible is absolutely true, because the Quran says, yes, there was a crucifixion. Yes, there was someone who looked exactly like Jesus in the cross. So what's our problem? The problem is the Quran saying that Allah is a cheater and he is a liar and he cloned someone look like Jesus, and now we have to believe that a guy who came 600 years after Jesus saying to us, This is, was not Jesus. It was someone look like him. A guy from Saudi Arabia who don't speak even his good even his Arabic is funny. The Muslim, they say he do not know how to write his name or to read his name. He want to teach us philosophy and history. This is what the Muslim want to say to us. We have thousands of manuscript, not only manuscript, we have something called the icons. Do you know, anyone knows what is the mosaic is? Anyone knows what is the mosaic? We have an art which is more clear than books. Why? Because it's made of images. The story of Jesus and the cross. We have icons go to the time of Jesus when the Christians, they start making churches under the ground. Those icons are made from small stones, which mean years will not change them. We have history. We have historians who are not Christians. They spoke about the crucifixion of Jesus. So not only we have a book, and actually, the more time come, the more we discover more books confirming the books we have. And just to show you something stupid in the Quran, as usual. Do the Quran deny the Bible? Read with me carefully. How many of you took a note of this verse before? Chapter 2, verse number 89. And when there's come into them a scripture from Allah, which is the Quran, confirming that is in their possession. Do you see it, guys? Do you see it? Confirming what? What is in their possession? In Arabic, it is lima ma'ahum, to what is with them, is with them. So Muhammad, he in his book, he confirmed that he musaddiqan, actually musaddiqan, not only confirming, he believe in what with them, not only confirming, he believe in what is in their possession right now. And this is your Quran. ولما جاءهم كتاب من عند الله مصدقا لما معهم وكانوا من قبل. The rest of the verse. A book came from Allah, which is the Quran, confirming and believing in what is with them. So what is with them at that time? Jesus was on the cross. What was with them at that time is what is written by Paul, by Mark, by Luke, by John. What was with them at that time? It was written in Revelation. What was written in the Old Testament? What was written in the book of Genesis? What is written in all the Bible, the Torah? So he is confirming what is with them and believing in that. So how you came after you say Quran says that did not kill Jesus? What does that mean? That's me, Muhammad, saying, okay, I believe in what in your Bible, but I have a news for you, additional news. Jesus was not Jesus. It was someone look like him. Do we have any Muslim want to say something smart? Additional to all the stupidity we saw in those arguments they keep saying to us in their videos. By the way, video Muslims, they don't debate you. The Muslim, they don't debate. Muslim, they go to website. Those who people, they ask questions, you see them in videos. Those, they know nothing. They go to our website, they print what is in the website, and they read from it. This is why this is not a debate. You see, a real debate is, call me now, open a challenge. Don't tell me the topic. Can they do that? They cannot. You see, all the Muslim debate, they want to, okay, what the topic? Okay, 2 months from now. Okay, why you want 2 months from now, and why you want to know the topic? The topic, Christianity versus Islam, anything. You throw at me what you want, I throw at you what you want. But because they are not people of knowledge, they are potatoes. They cannot do that. They need to know the questions to prepare the answers. Like yesterday, we have this guy. His name is Muslim proper, Abbas. You know Abbas. Abbas, he called me yesterday. Anyone remember what happened to Abbas yesterday? Anyone remember what happened to Abbas yesterday? The Arabian Prophet. No, it means in the corrupt Bible, they are hiding still. Have a truth in it. Look at this idiot. This is what it means. Well, the Quran says, what is with them? What hiding Bible? Guys, it is hiding Bible, brother. No, it's mean in the corrupt Bible, they are hiding. Still have a truth in it. And now, because it says confirming what is with them, not some of what is with them. You are a potato as usual. You never change. In China, they say he went as a donkey. He never came back as a horse. And this is Abbas. We send him to England. He live in London, but still the same. That will be the case if it says confirming some of what they have, not confirming that in their position. And not only that, Muhammad, he took an oath on the book of the Jews, saying, I believe in thee and the one who sent thee. Is that right? Did Muhammad take an oath saying, I believe in thee and the one who sent thee? This is the hadith in front of us. He came to the Jews, and the Jews, they brought for him the Torah. And then Muhammad, he said, and he took the question, respecting the Torah. Look how hypocrite he is. And then he says, after he put the Torah in the top of the cushion, that the Torah was brought, and then he withdraw the cushion from beneath him, and he placed the Torah on it, saying, I believe in thee and in who revealed thee. The whole Torah, not some of the Torah, potato. Try better. Why you don't let your mommy call me or daddy? Hadith is not sahih. Quran is not sahih too. Muslim proper, you mentioned that the book of Daniel. Where is the book of Daniel in the Quran? Where we can find the name Daniel in the Quran? What happened to this name in the Quran? As long as you are mentioning that name. Any Muslim want to help us? Why that name is not exist in the Quran? You just said the book of Daniel. Okay. Is this name exist in your book? What happened? Your prophet, he dropped the story. He dropped the whole book. What happened? Oh, this is the book of denial, not Daniel. It's called the Quran. Let me show you something. One of you actually asked me to speak about Ishmael. If Ishmael, Muhammad is, the Muslim, they say that Muhammad is from Ishmael, right? I thought you said denial. Yesterday you said to me, Ted, you wanted to say read, right? Read, you said Teed. Listen, Abdul. Somebody asked me and said about Muhammad is from Ishmael. Who's a Muslim can prove to us that Muhammad is from Ishmael? Where we can find that? The Quran is in front of me. Who is a Muslim want to give me a verse in the Quran saying that Muhammad is from Ishmael? Anyone want to show us one verse in the Quran saying that Muhammad is from Ishmael or from Abraham? Like it or not, Yeshua is the way. I mean to that. Thank you guys for the support, for those people who they are helping us. Any Muslim can show us a verse. Hadith mention it. So in the hadith, it says that Muhammad is from Ishmael. In the Quran, it's not. Why? So Allah, he did not forget to tell us that Jesus is a son of Mary, and Jacob is a, you know, actually he did not say who is Jacob. Jacob suddenly became Israel. Allah have all kind of names, stories about the ant, stories about the ant. She saw Suleiman, Suleiman the son of who, David the son of who. You know, I mean, all the names, and suddenly Muhammad never mentioned in the Quran that he is a son of Ishmael. Why? A second ago, this Abdul, he said the hadith is wrong, and now he is saying it's in the hadith. Do you see the hypocrisy and the stupidity? When he won't, he refused the hadith. When he won't, he accept the hadith. Abbas, give me the hadith says that. Give me the hadith saying that Muhammad is from Ishmael. Can we have that hadith from you? Mayday, mayday. I want the hadith where it says that Muhammad is from Ishmael. Can you give us the hadith? Just for fun. And let me get you busted. The hadith you are quoting is sahih. You did not quote anything. Give me the hadith. I'm quoting. Which hadith is not sahih? Abdul, which hadith is not sahih? The hadith I showed you yesterday is sahih. And the day before it is sahih. And the day before it is sahih. And the day before it is sahih. As an example. Okay, hold on. Abdul, listen. As an example. This hadith, is it sahih or it is not sahih that the sun set in a boiling water? Abdul, is this hadith sahih or it is not sahih? Hello, I'm waiting for your answer. Is this hadith sahih where you're a prophet saying the sun set in the murky water, boiling water? Is it sahih or it is not sahih? Oh, now he wanna play dead. Well, it is sahih. Okay, is the hadith about your prophet saying, explaining the sun setting every day, that the sun goes every day from the east to the west, and she dumped herself under the throne of Allah, which is in the top of the boiling water, is it sahih or it is not sahih? Brother, is this hadith is sahih or it is not sahih? Once I was with the prophet in the mosque at the time of the sunset, the prophet said, oh Abu Dhar, do you know where the sunset? Look, Muhammad, he's like a, he challenged you, like, do you know? Muhammad, you like to show off, like, I know you do not know. Oh, hey Abu Dhar, do you know? Abu Dhar, he said to him, because he knew Muhammad, he loved to be blown like a balloon. You have to make him big. He said, I replied, Allah and his apostle know best. Muslims are mushrikeen. They are associating the name of Allah, the knowledge of Allah, with the knowledge of a man. His name is Muhammad, which means the praised one, which means God. He said, it goes and prostrate under Allah's throne. So Muhammad explained the sun setting, saying that the sun goes. And what goes where? To prostrate itself under the throne. And he explained, he cannot keep his mouth shut. Muhammad, he cannot keep his mouth shut. He has to give more details. He said, and that Allah saying statement, the sun runs into its fixed course. This is the course of the sun. Every day go and sit under the throne of Allah, which is in the water, which Allah is sitting in the top of it. Is that sahih or it is not sahih, Abbas? You know, Abbas, I'm thinking to make a Barbie look like you and hang it on my car mirror just for fun. I need to be laughing from time to time. Where are you? Is this hadith sahih or it is not sahih? Hello? Play it dead now. He is searching Google now, trying to find where it says that Muhammad is from Ishmael. He have to go and he gave us a finger. This is the only stupid religion in the world. They give you a finger thinking they are witnessing for God. When I came to America, I was saying to myself how nice the American in the highway. I was driving so slow and everybody putting a finger out of his car. I thought they are saying hi. And now Abbas is giving us a finger. And supposed he is witnessing for God. Have you ever heard of a people witness toward God by a finger? Any Abdul? Who is here first time? Don't forget, guys, to subscribe if you like what we do here. If you don't like it, still you have to subscribe because we are Arab and don't play with us. I will call my cousin Osama bin Laden. And does it need all this time to find the hadith where it says Muhammad is from Ishmael? So Muslims, they cannot find one statement that Muhammad is from Ishmael in the Quran. This is what Abbas saying to us. Do you believe it? How stupid this religion is? Did Allah forget that or what? Allah was busy telling us the story about the end. By the way, one of the reasons to convert in Islam is the story of the end. I don't know if you know about it. Before we leave, actually, we are here in the chapter of Al-Baqarah. How many of you knows what Al-Baqarah mean? What Baqarah mean? Who knows what Baqarah mean? You see the name, it says Baqarah. Is my chair making noise, guys? My chair is very old. It's making noise when I move. I'm trying not to move. Cow. Why the chapter called the cow chapter? Why? Anyone knows why? Anyone knows why? Pause the hadith, Abdul, so we can laugh. Why it's called the Baqarah, the cow? Give me the hadith in Skype, Abbas, so we can laugh. According to the chapter of Al-Baqarah, there's a guy, he killed somebody. And the dead man, nobody knows what happened to him. So they wanted to find out who is the killer. And the brother, they came to Moses. And they told him, how we will know who is the one who killed this guy. So Allah told Musa to bring beef. Read the story, chapter 2, verse 72. And remember, when ye slew a man and his greed concerning it, Allah brought forth that which ye hiding. Okay, how Allah will bring forth which ye hiding? Listen to this. And we said, submit him with some of it. What is that? Who was the Muslim who tell us, submit him with some of it? What some of it what? Guys, do you notice there's something missing in the story? Did you notice the stupidity? Submit him with some of it. Some of it what? We have to go a little bit in the verses before it, where Allah, he have a flight of thought. So he jumped from place to place. It's a cow. But if you read it, you will not notice that he's talking about the cow, because what this have to do? They killed the cow, they sacrificed the cow, okay. And then he says, submit it with some of it. Some of it what? It doesn't say. And this is how Allah bring the dead to life. This is how Allah bring the dead to life, by beating them by beef. Oh boy. You see, the hadith you are quoting for me, it's not your prophet saying that. So this is stupid of you to post for me. And let me give you a bad news, Abbas. I feel sorry for you. I really feel sorry for you. You went to Ibn Kathir. Sorry, to Al-Bukhari. I want Abbas to say to me he accept any hadith from Al-Bukhari speaking about his prophet, where he is from, or who he is. Do you agree, Abbas? Say yes, please. Abbas, do you agree with Sahih al-Bukhari, whatever he says about your prophet? Do you agree? Abbas? Abbas? Are you there? Do you agree, Abbas? Say yes or say no. Guys, okay, he will not say. What do you think? He will say yes or no? Who can guess what he will say? Read it for everybody. Stop putting conditions. I'm not putting conditions. What you gave me is not hadith saying that you're a prophet from Ishmael. It is someone saying that. The hadith you gave me saying that Muhammad is from Ishmael. But is that Muhammad saying that? No. Yes or no? Abbas, yes or no? So you have no proof whatsoever, even from your books. Let me get you busted. Ishmael, according to the Muslims, he did marry from the tribe of Jahm. Jahm are the enemy of the tribe of Muhammad. So how Muhammad can be from Ishmael? Any Muslim can tell me? How those are the enemy of Muhammad, and the tribe of Quraysh, they kicked Jahm from Mecca. which means that not a single person who lived there is from Jerham or Jahm. So how Muhammad is from Ishmael? Anyone knows? Secondly, the Quran get your prophet busted. Ishmael was a prophet to who? Muslim Piper Abbas. Ishmael was a prophet to who? Can you give me the answer, please? Ishmael was a prophet to who? Guys, do you think he will answer? Do you think any Muslim he would dare to answer? Ishmael, you Muslim, you say Ishmael was a prophet. He was a prophet to who? No, it doesn't say that. You see, you have to give me a proof saying that Muhammad really was from Ishmael. What you're saying to me that this is from the son of etc., the son of etc., and that tribe is where Muhammad descended from. But it's not even Muhammad saying that. Secondly, Ishmael, he was a prophet to who? Who is a Muslim when I tell us? The Muslim, they say Abraham was a prophet, Ishmael was a prophet, Jacob, Isaac, they were a prophet. Question, Ishmael, he was a prophet to who according to Islam? Who want to give me the answer? Are you searching Google Abbas? They say to you he was a prophet to Mecca. Okay, who live in Mecca? Muslims, who live in Mecca? Guys, be my witness. This is Abbas. He gave us an answer after searching for long. Let us put Abbas text on the screen. Where is Abbas text? The prophet Ishmael is prophet of Allah to his people, most likely the Arab. Guys, did he say the Arab, or I am the one saying that? Okay, so how Allah, he says Allah never sent the messenger to the Arab before, to the people of Mecca before. Anyone? Are you there, Abdul? Abbas, who was the messenger before Muhammad to Mecca? You Muslims, you claim Abraham and Ishmael. Is that Quran or this is a weak hadith? Any Muslim? Mayday, mayday. If there is any warner, any messenger came to the Arab before Muhammad, is that a message about Moses or about Muhammad? Let us play with Abbas. Abbas, this is about Moses or about Muhammad, brother? Abbas, hello. If there is any messenger to the Arab before Muhammad, If there's none, that means the Muslims are lying about Abraham and Ishmael. They went to Mecca and they built the Kaaba and they warned the Arab. This is a verse about Muhammad. We never send before you a warner to those people. Never. Are you there? So if Ishmael was in Mecca and he is the one who built the Kaaba with Abraham, that means not only there is a warner, there is the father of the prophet was there, Abraham himself, and his son is Ishmael. But the verse in the front of us says, no warner came before you. You know what? Maybe you don't like this translation.
You see, you can't play this game because you Muslims claim that the one who built the Kaaba is Abraham, and the Quran even witnessed for that. So we are talking about the same city. We never sent before you to your people. Aren't you the one who just said to me that Ishmael is the father of the those Arabs, the father of the tribe of Muhammad, and Ishmael is a prophet? So I'm going with you. Muhammad is from Ishmael. This is your lie. Your lie now is causing you to be in trouble. So Muhammad is from Ishmael, and Ishmael is the father of the tribe of Muhammad, and Ishmael, he warned his people. So if his people is the tribe of Muhammad, that means the Quran is a lie. And where Ishmael live? In Mecca. And which tribe is his? You just confirmed to us. Everybody is my witness. You said that Muhammad is from Ishmael. Guys, did he say that? Did he say that? This is the text of our brother Abbas. It's in front of you. He sent me this. He sent it to me as image. So a second ago, you were working hard, and this is how, this is why they say to you, when Christian Prince ask you a question, don't ever say yes, never say no, because he have a trap for you. Idiot. This is what you send me. You are working for the last 20 minutes to confirm to me that Muhammad is from Ishmael, and Ishmael is the father of this tribe. And where Ishmael live in Mecca, and what he did, he built the Kaaba with his father. But the Quran says that this village, your people, Muhammad, they never have a warner before you. Never. This is how we do it. Guys, look at this. If Ishmael brother, he is the father of the Arab, does not mean that he live in Mecca where he live. So you are saying the Quran lying that Abraham he did build the Kaaba and his son. So if Abraham, okay, hold on, guys. If Muhammad is from Ishmael, you just said that, and Ishmael move, still Muhammad is from Ishmael. And the people of Muhammad is the people of Ishmael. Let us say Ishmael, he went to the moon, to Alaska. Still, this is the same tribe, Abdul. I mean, look how silly you are, trying to save yourself from the humiliation after what you said. Secondly, they did live in Mecca. Silly and stupid. Silly, literally. Ishmael never been in Mecca, and the proof in front of you. How many of you took reference? Isn't this is a clear contradiction for what all the Muslims they claim? This is how easy to get them busted from their foolish book, from their foolish prophet mouth.
As simple as that. Muhammad, he said that Allah never sent a messenger before him to people of Mecca. And remember here, it says, your people. If you don't like the translation, by the way, I can change it. Wait, let me do that. Maybe you don't like this translation. This is Bictal. Which translation you like, Zuku? Which translation you like? Here, this is customer service. You like Yusuf Ali? Okay, Yusuf Ali. Here we go, Yusuf Ali. Hey, Yusuf Ali, what do you like to say to Brother Abbas? Read it. Abbas, I'm trying to help you here. Look what Yusuf Ali, he said. He says he is speaking about Moses. Is that about Moses or about Muhammad? Look how stupid this book. One verse speak about Musa, the second verse speak about Muhammad. And we had not sent thee to Quraysh to who? So Abbas was trying hard to tell me that Quraysh is the people of Ishmael, and Muhammad is descendant from Ishmael, and now it's not no more. And by the way, it doesn't say they're Quraysh, it says your people. Who is a Muslim would like to call us? Who is a Muslim would like to call us? Okay, guys, how many of you today will download the video and share it in your channel? Let us see how many. Give me one. How many of you? Please don't forget to download it and share the videos in your channel. All right? Any video is about Islam, please take it and share it. If the video is not about Islam in my Arabian Prophet or the other channel, don't download it. Only videos about Islam, you know, I would like you to have it. And those who speak other languages will be great if you add subtitle in your language so you can help your people, your family. Remember, you are doing it, you know, you are, look, you see, all of us, we share the blessing for saving the Muslims. We love them. And saving even the Christians so they will not be deceived. So what we do have a double edge. One, to save the Christian from being deceived by false teaching of Muhammad. And one, to save the Muslims from the false idiot Muhammad. So when we add subtitled in any language, like we have, I'm so grateful to see the Indonesian brothers and sisters from Indonesia adding subtitles, and they have hundreds of thousands of viewers and subscribers. Actually, some of them, they have nothing but my videos, but yet they have more subscribers than me. You believe it? Very beautiful. I am not a person who will be jealous from you for having more subscribers. Actually, I would like you to have more. Some people, they are desperate. I want to my channel, because this is not my channel. This is your channel. It's what I do is not for me. I'm sick of this cult. I wish one day I go and never speak about it again. Honestly, it's a wish. I'm the last one to speak about this cult. Take reference, take notes, educate yourself, because my friend, education is amazing. Everything on you change when you are educated. You believe it or not, this is the truth. Yeah, Abbas, you will ask me about the Bible. Okay, why you want to jump to the Bible now? The Quran says Allah, he confirmed with is what is with them. And now you want to ask me a question about the Bible? And what about this? You want to jump it too? So look what the Muslims they do. I want to ask you a question about the Bible, CB. Can I call you later, tomorrow? How many times you ask me questions about the Bible? We get you busted. One more, one less doesn't hurt, Abbas, but still you cannot answer. I always accept your challenge. Have you ever called me and asked me about the Bible? I did not answer you. Okay, Abbas, what about you? Call me right now. Abbas, you call me right now and ask me about the Bible. And this is my challenge. You answer about this verse. You give me the question about the Bible, and everybody will be laughing either at me or at you. Go ahead. You know what? I will call you because I know you are a coward. You will not call me.
Peace be with you, brother.
Hey, call me brother again. Taqiyya. Okay, Taqiyya. Go ahead.
Yeah, peace be with you. I can't talk right now. I'm at work right now.
You are at work? So this is the good thing about hiring a Muslim. You hire a Muslim, you pay him a salary, he go to chat rooms.
No, but
never hire a, you know, look at this. How you can hire a person like this? You see how decent they are? You hire him, you pay him salary, and what he do? He sit in a chat room. Very decent people. So there is an idiot, he hired you, and now he's paying you by hour. And what you do? You go to Christian Prince chat because you are addicted to Christian Prince. You cannot sleep without me. You have to be spanked every night. You cannot talk right now. Why you cannot talk? Because I'm at work now. Either he is driving or he's at work. And by the way, when he's driving, he's working too. yeah, you work for yourself. I believe you. This, you are the same as Muhammad. He work for himself, not for Allah. This is why he says, "Who wanna give me money? Who wanna give me women? Any woman should give herself to the Prophet. You work for himself. You and Muhammad is the same. You work for yourself. You don't work for anyone." Isn't it true that Muhammad says that Allah said any woman she want to give herself to the Prophet? What does this have to do with God? Muhammad already had 13 wives and hundreds of sex slaves. What kind of God he make a verse saying, and any, hey brother, all those women, they can take their panty for the Prophet. Okay, what women? What women? Tell us, please. Please tell us. Look at this verse, guys. Look at this verse. O Prophet, we made for you lawful thee the wives. The wives are made lawful. Don't you think it's too late? They are already his wife, you idiot. Your wives. So you have many wives, the Quran confirmed that. And whom has bait your their dower? And those are right to process. So Muhammad, he can rape the slaves. And the prisoner of war. Okay, in unlimited numbers, thousands of women. And then, and whom Allah assigned to thee. Allah, you see those women, Allah assigned to thee, so Muhammad, he can use as a private part with them. They are assigned. Guys, do you see this is not my translation. Allah assigned to thee. What he assigned? Women, prisoners of war. Who is the one who assigned them to Muhammad? Allah. And the daughter of your uncle from your mother's side, and the daughter of your uncle from your mom's side, and the daughters of migrate from people from Mecca. Okay, who's left? And any believing women who detect herself to the Prophet. What? All of those? Would this have to do with God? What that will accomplish to Allah? When Allah saying, Muhammad, you can use your private part everywhere. You have unlimited. The neighbor of the neighbor, the daughter of your daughter, and the daughter of and the women they immigrate from Mecca, and any women, any believing women, she offer herself to the Prophet. And look what Aisha, she said, Aisha, she is not stupid, even though she is a kid. She noticed that Muhammad, is a scam. She said, "Inna Rabbuka yusaru'u ila hawaka ya Muhammad." What does that mean? I see that your God, he rush into your desire, Muhammad. His God, he rushed to what? To the desire. What desire? Sex. Sex desire. The God of the Almighty, he is in his office thinking, who is the woman I will let sleep with Muhammad? And he starts writing. And look what Aisha, how she got that Muhammad is nothing but a scam. Aisha, she said, and this is a very sahih, authentic hadith, I felt jealous of the women. How many women who offer themselves to Allah, offer themselves. Is that a hippie? Is that a Santa Cruz in California where the hippie started? Take me, baby. Call me, baby. So Muhammad, he made a verse saying, any believing woman, she wanna offer herself so we can do boom boom. Like what? So I felt jealous of women offer themselves to Allah Messenger and said, huh? Then when Allah the Exalted, glorious, revealed this, you may differ any one of them you wish, or take anyone you wish. What happened here, Muhammad, when he said any woman she can offer herself, some women who they are not really good looking, with my respect to all ladies or old, they offer themselves too. But Muhammad, he told them any woman can offer herself. He forgot to say any pretty women. So he made a verse after it saying, and Allah told me I can differ any one of them as I wish. Which meant, okay, you know what? Allah, he said, any woman she can offer herself, but I don't have to take you. Muhammad, he made the verse, he opened the door of his house, he found the women in the age of 70 offering themselves. He said, oh, what I did, I forgot to add the pretty and young. Look, what I will do, how I can get out of this? Now they are offering themselves to me, what I will do? So he made a verse, as you see, saying, and Allah said, you may differ any one of them as you wish, and you can take to bed as you wish. This is obviously, this is from God. This is not Muhammad doing that. So look what Aisha, she said. She said, guys, you read with me. Can you read? She said, who said that? Aisha, first-hand witness of the scam of Muhammad. It seems to me that your Lord has to satisfy your sexual desire. What desire we're talking about? Sexual desire. This is about sex. Do you see it? This is a God who will rush to satisfy your sexual desire. All scam leaders, they share one thing, who claim to be prophets. They want your money, and they sleep with the women who believe in them as a prophet. If you don't believe me, you can go right now and search in Google. All cult leader, they share one thing. And when I say cult leader, it's not just somebody is maybe a priest or something. No, somebody claimed to be a prophet speaking for God. They want two things: your money, which make them in power, control, and your women. All of them. Let me see, there is a list. All right. This is an article. I just searched Prophet Google, peace upon him, who sent to us by Jibreel. All right. What do cult leaders have in common? Okay, what they have in common? All right. All of them, they have things in common. Let us see. I don't know what this article is saying. Let us see here. Okay, here we go. They want to have sex with their followers and they want your money. They speak about empowering women, and it's, you know, whatever their time needed so they can fool you. And at the end of the day, they sleep with the women who follow them, and they take the money of those who follow them. This is exactly Muhammad. And Aisha is not a fool. She noticed right away that Muhammad, his God, is fishy God. He hastened. Allah, he rush for what? I mean, do Muhammad, what is the point of this verse, guys? Anyone can tell me. Who is a Muslim can tell me why Muhammad, he needs such an order from Allah that any woman, she can give herself to him. Muhammad already have 13 wives. And he have, as you see in the verse, saying all the women, the prisoners of war, they are lawful for him to rape. So why he need any Muslim woman she can give herself? What does this have to do with God? Is that will make Islam strong? Is that will confirm that Muhammad is a prophet? Obviously, Muhammad is asking something for his own benefit, and this is sexual. It's a shame. It is a shame. If you remember yesterday, we showed you a hadith, and Abbas is the one who called me. Who remember yesterday what was the hadith? When we ask Abbas about this, the Prophet advising one of the men of his men to go and find a child to marry. What Abbas, he said to me, you remember yesterday? It was just yesterday. He said, how you know, Christian Prince, that this guy is not 17 years old and the Prophet is saying to him, marry someone young? I ask Abbas, where you get this as a 17 years old from? The coward, he hang up and run. And I ask him before he hang up, are you saying if you are 17 years old, you can marry a child? He said, no. It's recorded. It's yesterday. It's in the video. Go watch it. And then I said, okay, if 17 years old cannot marry a child, 6 years old, how your prophet did marry 6 years old? I cannot compare between my Lord, the Messiah, and the faith of this man. It's an insult for our Lord. How holy he is. How amazing he is. You see, a person who can raise people from death, he can heal the blind. Imagine today, I got little power of the Christ, of Christ. Let us say I can make just the blind see. Just this is the only miracle the Lord he can give me. And I am a selfish person. I use his power to make money. How much money I can make just by making the blind see? You know what I mean? Jesus never took a penny. Jesus never owned a slave. Jesus never asked for return. Jesus never asked for anything for himself. All it was about us, saving us. While Muhammad making verses claiming that God said to him, any woman she can give herself to you. What kind of a man this? What kind of ethic? Imagine I put a sign in my door where I live. It says, any woman she can give herself to me. The neighbors will kick me out from the area, because this is really an insult to them, insult for the society. Isn't it, guys? What do you think? If a man, he put a sign in his door, big sign, and have the signature of God, any woman, she can give herself to this guy. Why? Because he's a prophet. So if you are a prophet, you are going to sleep with our wives, yes. And not only that, the Muslim book says the following, and I changed the Muslim to say I'm lying. If the prophet's eyes fall into a woman, her husband must divorce her immediately. Who is a Muslim saying I am lying? Who is a Muslim willing to take the challenge and say, Christian Prince, I challenge you to show me the reference of what you just said, that if the prophet, his eyes fall into a woman, her husband, which means she is married, he must divorce her immediately so the prophet can sleep with her. Who is a Muslim want to challenge me? Anyone? Any two? Mayday. We need a Muslim. He can call me right now and say, we have somebody saying Nathan. His name is Nathan. He's saying, show us Arabian. Are you a Muslim, my friend? I want a Muslim to call me and say to me, I challenge you to show us what you just said, that if the prophet, his eyes fall into a woman, her husband must divorce her so the prophet, he can have her. Who want to do that? Who is the hero who want to do that? Obviously, you Muslims agree that this is a shame. That's why they want to call. And you know it's true. Otherwise, you will be all over me. And listen what will happen. After we hang up and I go, the Muslim, they will start posting comment, or they will make videos exposing the lies of a Christian prince. Why you don't call me and expose my lies here now so everybody will laugh? You can record it. You can record the conversation with me, post it in your channel. Who want to do that? I have a blocked them on Skype. That's not true. I block only people who use bad language and kids. And same time, even if I blocked you, you can make a new name in 2 seconds and you call me right now. That is a false excuse. It's a Skype. It takes you 2 minutes to make a Skype name. So if the name, as you said, the blocked, you can make a new name and call me now. And people will hear your ring and people will hear you speaking to me. That is a false excuse. I blocked, guys, I blocked 1.1 billion Muslims. Now all of them, they are blocked them. Any Abdul? I can show you, I have a billion blocked here. A Muslim wanna answer me, all the ustad of the Muslims, they wanna answer me, but I blocked them. Nobody can block you because you can change the name in 2 seconds. Red, you were joking? Okay, Red. Because you gave a loan to Allah, Allah forgive your sin. Well, as long as you are giving a mortgage to Allah, I mean, isn't it obvious that this guy is a scam? Have you ever heard of a prophet? He says to you, if you give me money, Allah forgive your sin. Not only Allah forgive you your sin, like our brother here, he gave $20. That's it. Allah now will make it 40 for you, and he will forgive your sin. What do you want more? Huh? Are you there, Red? Look what will happen now. Your $20, they became 40, and your sin is forgiven. The other one who gave 100, the brother there, is he will Allah will make it 200 and will forgive your sin. It's great. Why people don't want to put their money in the bank? And why you want to go to the stock market or even buy a real estate? Just give Allah 100, he give you back 200. But Allah will give you the 200, brother, after you die in the judgment day in the heaven, brother. How Allah is going to double it for you? I know, my friend, that you are he's a Christian. I'm just joking. Isn't it obvious he is a Christian? I mean, he's a Muslim and he's donating for me. Come on. That would be weird. He understand. I'm just criticizing the scam of Muhammad. What Muhammad is teaching the Muslims, if you give Muhammad money, Allah forgive your sin. That is a scam itself. Because since when you can buy forgiveness by money? That is what is a scam is about. Right? Anyone he says to you, if you give him money, God will forgive you, he's lying to you. Because that's mean that if you are rich, you are the first one to go to heaven, you commit sin every day, and you do just to give money. Here we go. More people asking for forgiveness of sin from Allah. This is why, my friend, we are following the Messiah. He is the King of Kings, but yet he have no money. He is the King of Kings, but he don't have palaces. He don't have horses. He don't have slaves. He don't have soldiers. He is the King of Kings, but he live between us, between the poor. He is the King of Kings, but he said, if you don't let me wash your feet, you don't belong to me. Yeah, we have people from Russia listening to us. That's wonderful. God bless all everybody. That is Jesus, my friend. Jesus want to wash your feet. Muhammad, he want your wives in his bed without panties. What the Lord he said about serving? Anyone remember? What the Lord said about serving? The master is the servant. Not the opposite. To be a master, you have to serve. Muhammad, he wanted to be the master, and you serve him. He wants your money, he wants your women, he wants you to be his slave. This is why we cannot compare. Do we have any Muslim here want to say something? When Jesus said, the greatest among you is the one who will be your servant. Was Jesus mistaken? Actually, yes. That is the greatest of us. Is the one who will serve. Because of that, he is the great. He is not selfish. How many times we spoke about fighting being selfish? You see, selfish person, he don't serve others. he want to abuse and use, for he concentrate on himself only. While in the Bible it teach the opposite. For God, he loved the world. So what he did? He sent his only begotten son. So God is serving us by sending his own son. And what his son he do? Another service, which nobody can do. Saving us willingly, to the point even he is willing to sacrifice his own blood. That is the greatest. The greatest is the one who humble himself. The proud is a fool. This is why Jesus said to them, I want to wash your feet. They said to him, Lord, what are you doing? He said, listen, if you don't let me do it, you don't belong to me. So while Muhammad was seeking more women, fabricating verses claiming that God told him to take more women to his bed, any woman she can offer herself, and the very simple question you ask yourself, be honest with yourself if you are a Muslim, what that have to do with God? How that can serve God? Women offering themselves to a man, his name is Muhammad, how that can serve God? How that can serve God's purpose? What is the purpose of Muhammad? Saving you? If Muhammad's purpose is saving you to take you to heaven, what does have to do any woman she can give herself to the Prophet so he can do boom boom with her? I challenge any Muslim to give me the purpose. What does have to do with God? Isn't it obvious that this guy is just working for his own benefit, for his private part? And you don't care for God. He is actually, he's not only using God, he's making fun of you. And he practiced that when his own son, imagine his own son by adoption, his name is Zaid. He went to the house of his wife and he flirted with the wife when she is married. She was what? She was married, chapter 33, verse number 37. Allah gave him verse saying, why you are hiding? Look, let me show you this guy he said. You know, I really like Muslims when they make a comment, because it help us to show you how Muslims think. Read carefully. Abbas, he said, CP, that is a pagan practice to sacrifice a human being for the sign for the sins of people. Okay, hold on. Be my witness. Did he just say that sacrificing a human being is a pagan practice? Did he say that? Okay. Do you Muslim believe that Allah he ordered Abraham to sacrifice his son? Are you there, Abbas? Abbas, now he will go under the bed, and he will not hear me. Abbas, you just said everybody heard you. Everybody saw your text. That asking to sacrifice a human being is a pagan practice. God, did he say that? Did he say that? Yes, he did. So when Allah he says to Abraham, sacrifice your son, you just confirmed, according to you, Abbas, that Allah is pagan. Are you there, Abbas? Are you there? Abbas, are you there? You just confirm, according to your logic, that Allah is a pagan God. For only pagan, according to you, they ask to sacrifice a human being. What happened to you, Abbas? Do you see, guys? I mean, it's boring for me. I cannot find even one Muslim. He have a little like a, I don't know. I mean, what kind of brain I'm dealing with? They don't have a brain when they talk to them. I mean, look at this. Like, you are talking to somebody as a kid. He's like 38, maybe 40 years old. And look what he's saying to us. Yes, Abbas.
Peace be to you, brother.
Peace with you, Abbas. Okay.
Yeah, you deliberately ignoring my messages, which I'm and I replied to you. I told you, read carefully. I said, for the sins of the people. Did Isaac or Ishmael, was he, Allah says, sacrifice him for the sins of the people? So you are busted again. Shall I call Dr. Zakanai?
Okay, let me ask you then. Guys, did he say for the sin? He said for the sin. Did he say that? Okay, so you are saying that if you sacrifice for the sin, that make you a pagan, correct?
Human being. Don't twist my words. I say, show me anywhere in Islam, it says human being sacrificed for the sins of the people. That is a pagan practice, my brother. Come back to Islam.
Okay, hold on. Show me where in Islam sacrificing a human being is to forgive sin. Allah, he asked Abraham to sacrifice his son for what reason?
That was his test. Just sacrifice.
No. Okay. Where it says that this is a test?
The Quran
is in front of me. Show me where it says that.
Show me what you are asking me for.
You are the one who said that this is a test. Correct?
Yes.
Where you learned that from?
You are the one who saying you imply.
Where you learned that from? Abbas, be honest with me. Where you learned that from?
Where do I learn what from?
That this was a test.
Because when he went to sacrifice, Allah was pleased with him, and Allah didn't make sure he didn't sacrifice
what,
his son.
What Allah he did then?
What Allah he did? Allah send a lamb.
Send the lamb. Allah send the lamb to who?
To Abraham.
Okay. So you are saying Allah, he sent the sacrifice. Is that correct?
Yeah, the lamb.
Okay.
The
lamb Allah is sacrificing to who?
Allah is sacrificing to what?
Okay, you said that. Okay, you said that the purpose of this. Hold on. You said the purpose of asking Abraham sacrifice is as a test, correct? Okay. Allah sacrificing for what purpose?
Allah is not sacrificing. Allah give the sacrifice lamb to Abraham to
sacrifice.
No, he
sacrificed. It says, "Wafadaynahu bidhabhin azim." We sacrifice. We ransom. This is your translation, Muslims. We ransomed him with a momentous sacrifice, a great sacrifice. Does it say that?
I have to see the screen. One second.
Okay,
I'm not on the screen. What chapter and verse you're reading?
You do not know what chapter I'm talking about. You do not even. So you are. You know the story, but you do not know where the story is.
The story, yes.
This is chapter 37, verse number 107.
Chapter 27, verses 107. Yeah, and we ransom him, with a momentum sacrifice. Yes.
Okay. Why Allah is giving sacrifice to who? So it is a sacrifice. Allah, he gave a sacrifice. Allah gave sacrifice to who?
Yes, sacrifice for what?
You tell me. I'm asking you, and this is my question. Allah gave sacrifice for what?
But the sacrifice was the sheep and not the human being.
I'm not asking you what. I'm saying for what? For what? Allah sacrificing for what? Abraham was sacrificing as a test. This is what you said, right? Okay, Allah sacrificing as what?
The crux of the matter is, in Islam, we do not believe in sacrificing human beings.
Don't tell me what I believe. I'm asking you a question. Don't jump. Don't jump like a monkey. Listen, don't jump like a monkey from a place to place. Allah sacrificing to who and why?
You are twisting the point here right now.
I'm not twisting. I'm asking you. You are the one who have knowledge. You are the one who have beard, not me.
Allah sacrificing. You said that Abraham sacrificed as a test. Allah sacrificing as what? As a test to himself?
No. Allah
okay, why sacrifice? Why Allah sacrificing? Like, why Allah sacrificing?
Like we do sacrifice on Bakra Eid, yeah? We do sacrifice.
Talking about Allah. Okay, you sacrifice. If you are sacrificing in the Eid to forgive your sin, do you want to show you your prophet saying that you have to sacrifice so Allah will forgive your sin?
To sacrifice for the sins. No, it's not.
Abdul, if I show you that if you sacrifice, Allah forgive your sin, what you would do?
Allah forgives sacrifice sins for many different reasons.
Okay.
Not only for
Do Allah forgive you if you sacrifice?
Because that is the good deed. Sacrificing.
This is not the question. If you why you have to sacrifice your blood in Ramadan, at the end of Ramadan, you sacrifice your blood.
You see, and you're changing the angle.
I'm not changing. You see, you are a coward. You will not answer. Allah sacrifice for what? You don't want to answer. Allah, why Allah sacrificing? Why Allah sacrificing? This is the question.
You need to show me when in Islam we sacrifice.
Listen,
human
I'm asking you. I'm showing you right now. You're running away. Allah sacrifice for what reason? Allah sacrificing for what reason?
Hello?
Allah sacrificing for what reason?
That is not the question. Allah sacrifice for what reason? We're saying human being.
I am the one asking the question. You are the Muslim. I will learn from you. Allah sacrificing for what reason?
We sacrifice animals for the sins. Yes.
Okay. We sacrifice animals for the sin. The guy, did he say that? So Allah sacrificing animals to forgive his sin?
Yeah, animals. Yes, he was in the Jews in the Torah.
So Allah, you just agree that Allah Himself He sacrificed animals so His sin will be forgiven.
Whose sin was forgiven?
Allah, because Allah is the one giving sacrifice. I'm asking you why Allah giving sacrifice. You said yes, we give sacrifice as animals to forgive our sin. Wonderful. So now I'm asking
you, can you prove that Allah's sins are forgiven? What are you talking about?
So why you don't tell me why Allah gave sacrifice? What's wrong? Allah gave sacrifice. Why? Okay, Abraham, he passed the test. Abraham, he brought his son to kill him. Abraham, he passed it. So now why Allah is giving sacrifice?
That's the sacrifice Allah giving. Allah giving is just like to celebrating that what he
celebrating what?
He passed in test. Allah celebrating it. Allah says Allah is pleased and
okay,
happy.
Okay, hold on. Okay, did Allah send fire to eat the sacrifice?
What? Sorry?
Did Allah send the fire to eat the sacrifice?
Send fire to eat the sacrifice.
Yeah.
Not to my knowledge. Where is it leading to? What's the point?
Okay, because if Allah is the one who took the sacrifice, who is the one celebrating? And why Allah is taking the goat to him? If this is a sheep or a lamb, and it's a great one, he's calling it even Zabhin Azim. It's a great, magnificent sacrifice. We do not know what is that exactly. Why he is taking it to himself?
Taking him to himself. Don't you know that Allah says in the Quran, when you sacrifice, your blood and meat doesn't reach Allah? It's what is your intention that reaches Allah. So what are you talking about?
Abdul, you will not answer. Okay, let me ask you. If you kill a human being, do you go to heaven in Islam?
So let's settle one thing first. We have established one thing for sure. In Islam, we do not believe in sacrificing human beings for sins. But
absolutely false. Because if you kill a human being, you go to heaven, yes or no?
Whoa, hang on a minute. Yeah, you're just going all over the place, man. What's wrong with you? Why are you so desperate, man?
Is that a Quran? Is that your Quran? Yes or no?
Stop asking yes or no question.
Well, this is your Quran. This is your Quran. Okay. Those who do jihad and kill the infidels, Allah, He fight them by your hands and heal your chest, and He will take you to heaven. So Allah is saying that the way to go to heaven is to sacrifice a human being, to do jihad and to kill. Yes or no?
What chapter and verse? Sorry? Oh, jihad. Oh, so you are implying because the jihad is you killing human beings.
Isn't it jihad? Okay, hold on. Isn't it jihad is an order of Allah to kill those who they are not Muslims?
So you're talking about the way kill the enemies, that you're going to go to paradise.
Hold on. Don't change the topic. Is it true? Either you say yes or no. So if you kill those who don't believe in Allah, if you kill those who don't believe in Allah, is that a sacrifice to make Allah happy or not?
Start again. You went too fast.
If you kill a human, and Allah promised you, if you kill a human who is the enemy of Allah, for he don't believe in Allah, you are going to go to heaven, correct?
And that human is what? Who? Enemy, yeah?
Enemy of Allah.
I just want to understand you. No, the enemies of Muslims, yeah? The enemies of Allah, enemies of Muslims, so you are killing them.
Okay, I will go with you. So you agree, if you kill the enemy of the Muslims, you go to heaven.
You don't have to go with me.
Abdul, there is nothing is called the enemy of Muslim, and you are a potato. The enemy of Allah. Read what your prophet in the Quran and in the Hadith says.
You are a potato,
and it's in front of you. I've been ordered to kill all mankind until they say there's no God but Allah and there's no prophet but Muhammad. So what is the message? What the message? I will sacrifice all mankind. Either they die and we shed their blood, or they have to convert to Islam. Yes or no?
Am I allowed to express my view?
Sure, go ahead.
Thank you very much, brother. So the point that we started with, that can we sacrifice for the sins of people? Now you equaling that one with killing the enemies, and Allah will give you reward. You saying that both things are same. That's what
you
said.
Who is the enemy? Who is the enemy? Enemy is anyone who don't believe in Allah.
Yes, sir, no. Answer me. Yes, sir. No. You think both things are same?
It's the same. Don't make me use word that I want to use. You are repeating yourself. You are an idiot child. I'm asking you.
Listen.
When Muhammad said, I've been ordered to fight all mankind. All mankind. Until what? Until they say the Shahada. So what the target? Saying the Shahada. Otherwise, the only way to secure their blood sacrifice. The only way to secure their blood is saying Shahada. Yes or no?
I'm a potato. Seriously.
Yes or
God.
No?
So we are talking about sacrificing human being for the sins. Is not equal to killing your enemies and a loving reward. It's
no,
not equal.
Actually, if you the second you shed your blood killing the enemy, Allah, he promised you that you will not go through hell at all. You will be in heaven immediately. Is that true or I'm lying?
Oh, well, it's right. If you kill a human being,
okay, you are killing the human being for the sake of who?
No, for the sake of the society, for the sake of the world, you destroying the evil from the world.
Okay, I want you to read this verse for me. You are a liar again. Read this verse for me. Here we go.
Oh, really? Okay.
Read this verse. All right. Did Allah, he says, kill them for the sake of Allah? Yes or not?
You want me to read it?
All those verses. Choose one. Which one you want?
I'm driving now, you know that.
You are driving right now, yeah, I know. Always
driving. Yeah, just read the verse. I'm listening. Read the verse.
Okay. Does it
say? Because I just called.
Does it say that this is for the sake of Allah? Yes or not?
Read it.
It's in front of you. Your English is better than mine. And if you like me to change the translation, let me know. Is there a translation you favor?
CP, tell me what chapter and verse is.
Chapter 5, verse number 54. What translation you
just
like to show you in the screen? It says, fight for the sake of Allah. Fight for the sake of Allah.
Yeah.
This is the purpose. Okay. And you fight for what? To kill people, right? Okay. So if you fight for the sake of Allah. Okay. You fight for the sake of Allah. What Allah will give you?
That's one of the good deeds for the sake of Allah you fight.
Okay, so you sacrifice, you are going to kill all a human being. If you are going to kill all a human being, the reward for killing all mankind who they are not Muslims is heaven. Yes or no?
No, that's not true. You don't supposed to kill because somebody's a non-Muslim. No. You're not supposed to. You only kill the enemies who are fighting with you. And all Allah right. says many times in
well,
the
you
Quran.
Are, you are a coward. You are a coward and a liar. Okay, read for me the chapter 29.
How come I'm a coward?
Read the chapter,
I call you
chapter
all
9.
The time,
chapter
all the time.
Chapter 9, verse 29. Don't, please. Chapter 9, chapter 9, verse 29. Does it say fight those who don't believe in Allah and the last day from the Christian and the Jews? Yes or no?
I will answer you. I will answer you right now. Well, your interpretation is wrong. I'll tell you, first of all, before I want to make one point, I'm a Muslim. And
a
Muslim is the one
you
who
submit
their will to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
You are not
listen
a Muslim.
To me.
You are not
listen
a Muslim.
To me now.
You said to
you
me,
me
you said to me,
you
peace.
Me coward.
You call me brother and you said to me, peace. Yes or no?
Everybody heard that. Yes, yes,
right.
yes, yes, yes.
How
yes.
that, how that will make you a Muslim? Isn't it the Quran says you will not find a Muslim who is nice to non-Muslims?
I already told you, Allah says, say peace to them and walk away.
No, this is,
peace
this
to
is,
who? The
this
ignorant,
is, this is
the
jahil
like you.
This is to run away.
So
Quran
like said,
chapter, let everybody
like
laugh
you.
At
about?
You. Let everybody laugh at you. You will not find, you will not. Any folk from the Muslims who believe in Allah and the last day, who he will be loving and good to those who they oppose Allah and his messenger. Yes or no?
Do you believe in the context? Everything is a context. Yeah?
Okay, no problem. What interpretation would you like me to read for you?
You believe in context, yes?
What interpretation?
You
the context will appear. The context,
context.
But, Abdul, the context will appear by the interpretation of the scholars of Islam.
You,
which one you agree
you,
to read it from?
Let me answer you chapter 9, verse 29. I'm answering
no,
you.
No, don't go there yet. Don't go there. Don't run. One by one. Which context? Which okay, you want to go to 9:29? Okay. Which interpretation
yes.
like me to read for you?
Can we read the Quran first?
Sure,
if
but
the
okay.
Words of the,
but instead
the
of,
words of the Quran
listen, listen,
is
listen.
Clear.
Instead of me and you shouting, let us go and take something we agree upon. Can we go as an example? You keep quoting for me Ibn Kathir. Can we go to Ibn Kathir? Do you is that okay with you?
I am keep quoting Ibn Kathir. What are you talking about? When did I quote Ibn Kathir?
Each time you call me, you say Ibn Kathir, and this is what you did last time too. It's recorded.
Oh. Everybody knows my position.
Okay, are you
everybody.
Saying Ibn Kathir is a liar?
Stop blanking.
Is Ibn Kathir
Stop
is a liar? Blanking. Why you don't want the scholars to
what
give?
I say,
okay, listen.
What
Abdul,
I say,
just shut up, you idiot. You're just a kid. The scholars agree with me, and this is why you don't want me to quote them. As simple as that. You are a coward. Why you don't want to read your scholars? This is not a Christian scholar. This is your scholars. You learn Islam from them. Those are your masters. Suddenly he don't want them. I said to him, okay, which one you want me to read for you? Anyone choose. He don't want. And yet he insists, do you agree to go with the context of that? Yes, it is go because the scholars will show us. I'm not asking you to read it from the book of the Jews. You're a scholar, and even I asked him to choose one. Last time he chose for me Ibn Kathir, the one before it Ibn Kathir, the one before it Ibn Kathir, and each time he quotes for us from Ibn Kathir, we get him busted. Coward. You are not a Muslim, you are a person who is practicing. If you mean what you say by saying to me peace, and you call me brother, and you mean it, the Quran says you are not a Muslim. And this is exactly what we can find in chapter 3, verse number 28. Any Muslim who is sincere, taking the non-Muslims as a friends or protectors. Do you remember, guys, this is the same guy, he says to me that the word awliya does not mean friends. And he asked me to go to Ibn Kathir. Do you remember? It's there. I don't know how many of you have the recording. You can post it. It's still in my page. And he is the one who says, go to Ibn Kathir. We went to Ibn Kathir. Ibn Kathir, he says, friends. Take them not as a friends. So how you call me brother? I will tell you why. Because either you are a stupid fool or you are practicing taqiyya. Going back to the topic, when you kill a human being and that will forgive your sin, as Muhammad, he said, that is a blood sacrifice for sin of a human being. The difference is, you Muslims kill a human being to go to heaven. In Christianity, we don't kill any human being. Anyone kill a human being to forgive sin? Hey, Christians, do you kill a human being to go to heaven? Did the Bible teach us to kill a human being to go to heaven? This is how stupid your argument is, because you said, and I put it in the screen, that killing a human being, sacrificing a human being, is a pagan practice. You said that. We Christians, we don't sacrifice a human being. We did not. Nobody did. If the Jews killed Jesus, does not mean Jesus. He said to the Jews, hey, kill me. And it is not us who killed him. And Jesus, by the way, he is in the flesh of a human being, but he is God. There's a huge difference between somebody teaching, okay, and you, if you want to forgive yourself, kill a human being for me every Sunday. That is a pagan. Jesus never taught that. Or what Jesus said, that I am going to give myself willingly. He knew what is going to happen in the future. And because he have an amazing love to us, even that will not stop me from saving you. Otherwise, Jesus, he did not teach us to sacrifice a human being. You are a liar. But it is your Quran saying if you kill a human being, you go to heaven. And we can find you tons of verses in the Quran where even Allah, he says that he bought your soul from you. He is the devil. Have you ever heard of a God saying, I bought your soul from you? He bought your soul from you? So you fight and you die for my sake, and this is why how you go to heaven? And what does that mean, you will go to heaven? That means your sin is forgiven. And what is sin in Islam? Sin in Islam is to be nice to the Christians and the Jews, to be nice to the Hindus, to be nice to those who don't believe in Allah. As you see, I showed you the verse saying, you cannot, you will not find one believing person who is going to take non-Muslims as a friend. Is that my statement? Absolutely not. This is your statement. Allah has bought from the believer their lives and even their wealth. For what? For what is the return? You sacrifice your blood. Blood sacrifice. You sacrifice your blood and you sacrifice the blood of the enemy of Allah. And that will give you the garden. It's in front of your eyes. Where Jesus says, if you go and kill people, I will give you heaven. Where Jesus says, if you kill someone, I'll forgive your sin. The Quran says that clearly. And this is the Quran, chapter 9, verse 111. I'm not going to waste my time with the kid. We show him, we say, okay, what scholar you want? This is an academic talk, not kids talk. If the Christians, maybe the Christians, they have wrong understanding. And you are a person who don't even, you are not qualified even to read your Quran. You cannot even read your Quran. Who are you? You are no one. Since you deliver pizza does not make you a pizza expert. We show them a verse from the Quran and we say, okay, let us see how Muslims understood this verse, not how Christians, not how we understand the verse. They don't want to do that. How your scholars for centuries, for the last 14 centuries, understood this verse, all Muslims, they don't want to do that. So it is you who do blood sacrifice. And by the way, I don't want to forget the other issue here, that the first one who asked for blood sacrifice is Allah. Anyone knows when? When the first time Allah, he asked for a blood sacrifice? Anyone knows? Who remember? Exactly. The story of
No, not the story of Noah, the story of Adam and his children. The first two children of Adam, the Muslim, they believe that Allah, he gave, he made Eve give birth each time to a twin. Twin, but the twin male and female. So the first twin is a boy and a girl. The second twin is a boy and a girl. And Adam wanted to marry the male from the first twin to the female from the other twin. Suppose that will make a difference, as if she is not his sister. Look how silly, I mean, the story. And one of the female twins, she have a cross eyes. Look at this problem. And now the brothers, both of them, they want to marry the women who don't have a cross eyes. So Allah inspired Adam, told him, ask your sons to give a sacrifice. One of them, he sacrificed zucchini. The other one, who sacrificed a sheep. Which one Allah, he took? A sheep. Clearly saying, okay, Muslim, you know, even though it's getting late, but let me give you last spanking before I go. Muslim Abbas, he said this. Let me show, I will put it on the screen. This is what he said, be my witness. 929 is a clearly saying, pay the tax. There is no fight between the Muslims and the Jews. You are a liar and you have no dignity. I'm not insulting you, but you have no dignity. Let us see really what the verse is saying. What tax? Where it says pay tax, and where it says no fight, you liar, coward. You are a coward. You have no shame. This is the verse. Guys, let us say fight. He said there's no fight. He said 929, there's no fight. The first word in the verse says kill. Fight in Arabic is qatilu, which means kill, fight to kill against those who don't believe in Allah from the scriptures, people, the Christian and the Jews. Why? Because they don't believe in Allah and the last day, and they don't forbid what is forbidden by Muhammad until either they die or they pay the jizya and you treat them law. What tax? Let us go to the book of Ibn Kathir just to get you busted for the last spank before we go. Ibn Kathir, coward, you are just a coward, you have no shame, and you are a foolish, by the way. I mean, you bring like you help us always to make people believe that Islam is so stupid and so sick to the point Muslims are ashamed of it. This is what you are doing now. You're ashamed, you're trying to deny what is in your books because you are ashamed, otherwise you will not be denying it. If somebody show me a verse in the Bible, I will not say it's not there. But because you are ashamed, this is Ibn Kathir. And this is the interpretation. And feel themselves subdued means they will be, this is will be your constation for a closed market, blah, 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 for the result, blah, 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 blah. Okay, now they have to pay the jizya. This Abdul, he said this is a tax. Let us see. Let us see the tax. Fight against those who don't believe in Allah and the last days, etc., etc. And then he says, interpretation. Therefore, when the people of the scriptures disbelieve in Muhammad, they had no beneficial faith in any messenger or what of the messenger brought. Rather, they follow their religious because they confer, this is confirmed with their ideas, lust, and the ways of their forefather, not because they are Allah, law, and religion. So we are not, we don't belong to Allah. That's perfect, actually. I agree with that. We don't believe in this garbage, and we have nothing to do with Allah. And then he says, because the prophet, he gave good news, Muhammad advanced with command to obey and follow him, yet they did not obey him. Okay, all right, they don't not follow Islam. Continue. Fight against those who believe not in Allah in the last days, not forbidding what is forbidden by Islam. Okay, this is the honorable ayah was revealed with the order to fight the people of the book
after the pagan were defeated. Muhammad, he is a very, very sick person. In the beginning, he did not tell the Christian, the Jews, I will kill you. He was busy with the pagans. He finished from the pagan, it's time to you to be killed. The people entered into Allah religion in large numbers. So now Muhammad, he have a bigger army, so he can slaughter all the Christians. And the Arabian Peninsula was secured under Muslim control. Allah command his messenger to fight the people of the book, the Jews and the Christians. On the 9th years of Hijra, almost Muhammad is dying now, and he prepared his army to fight the Roman. Do you see it? The Roman did not come to Muhammad. They never came to Mecca. Roman never ever arrived to that city. And then the people, he called the people for jihad, announcing this is instant and destination. The messenger of Allah sent intent to various Arab areas around Al-Madinah and gather forces. He is the one gathering forces, not the Roman. And he called an collected an army of 30,000, some of from Al-Madinah and some hypocrites in around it. He is even forcing those who don't believe in Islam, who converted to Islam by force. Anyway, and then he says, look, until they pay the jizya, because they choose not to embrace Islam with willing submission and defeat. This is a jizya as a penalty with submission and defeat, humiliation. Read carefully. And feel themselves subdued, disgraced, humiliated. Abbas, he told us this is tax. Okay, Abbas, he pay tax in England. I don't know if he pay tax. Most of Muslims don't. But do you pay it with humiliation? Therefore, Muslims are not allowed to honor the people of the Dhimma or elevate them above the Muslims, for they are miserable, disgraced, and humiliated. Why you are lying, Abbas? I will tell you why. You are a Muslim, and what you expect? I'm not really upset from you. I mean, you are just being a perfect Muslim who lie 24 hours, 7 days a week. Even your prophet, he said, you can lie to three, your family, your friends, and your enemies. So who's left? You people believe that lying is the style of life, it's a good way to live. You follow a prophet, he said, lying is the best way to fix things between people. Is that your scholars, or this is the Christian understanding? The prophet said, don't initiate the salam to the Jews and the Christians. Did this guy, he says to me, brother, and he says peace. We ask him before why. He says, oh, he is speaking here about people who they are arrogant against Islam. Well, how you say to Christian prince, peace then? Do you see how stupid? He said that you cannot say peace to those who they are arrogant against Islam. So who is a Christian prince for you? He's not against Islam? Oh, boy. Yeah, you have a very little IQ. I feel sorry for you. I don't know how you pass your driving license test. Huh? Diarrhea of the mouth does not make you right. My friend, the one who have diarrhea with the mouth is you. You keep talking, but you never gave me a proof. I'm showing you proof. Anything I say, I open Muslim books, and this is your Muslim website, and I get you busted. It is you who have a diarrhea. Not me. Diarrhea is somebody, he keep talking, but he refused to show reference. And what reference we are asking for? Muslim reference. Scholars. Suddenly you don't want scholars. It is you who have a diarrhea. This is what your prophet said. And if you see them in the road, force them to the most narrow alley, which means force them to walk in the sewage. This is why the leader, the faithful Umar al-Khattab, Allah pleased with him, demand his well-known conditions to be met by the Christian, those conditions that ensure the continue of humiliation. Do you see it? And disgrace. To ensure the continue. Yet a potato like you, for you feel that you are low, you lie and you say peace to you, brother, thinking that by doing that, maybe you can protect Islam and practice in taqiyya. It doesn't work with us. You see, whoever diarrhea, it's your prophet. He cannot keep his mouth shut. The more he talk, the more he do diarrhea. Here we go. Your prophet saying that. If you see the Christians in the street, humiliate them, spit in their face. This is your problem. You have a prophet who don't keep talking. I mean, he keep talking and he do diarrhea. And now it's time to get him busted. Islam is dead, my friend. Don't try. Each time people watch my videos, people leave Islam. Go and search what's happening right now in Indonesia. Almost every church in Indonesia speaking about a Christian prince, the video of a Christian prince, mosque on Indonesia, the Muslims Ustad. My videos are translated to the Indonesian language like fire, and hundreds of thousands of Indonesians watching my videos. And you can guess how many Muslims in Indonesia live in Islam every day watching those videos. Just go, Abbas. You are just, I don't talk to kids. I don't talk to kids. How many of you ask me about the Bible and I get you busted, you idiot? I mean, you are an idiot. And you know what, Abbas? I will call you right now. Final spanking. You want to ask me about the Bible? Let us see.
Yeah, peace to you, brother.
Peace to you, yeah. Okay. You want to ask me about the Bible, Abbas? You want to ask me about the Bible, Abbas?
Yeah, I will call you tomorrow.
Are you sure? No. Why tomorrow?
I just got home.
Home? So you, when you are in the road, you say I'm driving. When you are home, I get home. So what we will do?
I just get out of
here, you idiot! You are just a kid. It's my fault. I'm talking to you. Never call me again. No, don't call me again. Just go out of here. Stupid idiot. What a kid. I feel sorry for your wife. I mean, what kind of woman she marry a man like this? What, there's no men left in England no more? No Muslim men left? From all Pakistan, there's nobody to marry? You? Act like a man. When he's talking, he say, I cannot answer you, I'm driving. When he's home, I'm home, I cannot answer now. And what? He is the one saying to me, he want to ask me about the Bible. I said, okay, let us call you and ask me about the Bible. Suddenly, he don't want to talk about the Bible no more. Get out. I will never even let you call me again. You are just a kid. Anyway, guys, I want to say thank you. And those who copy my videos, by the way, you can make them pieces. You can cut them pieces if the video is long. You know? Like you can choose the topic, like let us say we spoke about the cross, we spoke about contradiction, we spoke about many things. If you want, you can cut the videos into pieces and load it as pieces. All right, I want to say thank you guys for being here. And remember, for those who they are from Germany, my book Sex and Allah is already out in German language. Variant number one and variant number two, and very soon, Sex and Allah in the Dutch language, in the language of Holland, will be out too. All right, for those who they are interested. Thank you very much for being here. May the Lord bless you. And remember one thing: never hate the Muslims. Like I get upset, I get angry, you know. But I don't really hate this. This guy is a poor guy. But sometime, I mean, it's too much. I don't know. I cannot live with the stupidity. You know, like you have a limit of patience, you as a human. And stupidity is number one enemy for me, especially when somebody, he plays stupid in purpose. He can be smarter, but he in purpose, in order to avoid answering anything, he played dumb. Okay, Allah, he says, there's no warner before you, Muhammad, he will not answer it. Allah says, if you kill for me and you die for my sake, I send you to heaven. Is that a blood sacrifice? Yes, this is a blood sacrifice. You kill for him, you go to heaven. And you sacrifice to forgive your sin. And the first one who asks people to sacrifice is Allah. It's not the pagan. And the proof is in the Quran. All over the Quran. And the first one who orders somebody to bow down beside God is Allah. Your God, Allah, he teaches shirk. He ordered the angels to bow down to Adam. Additional to all stupid teaching, which beyond imagination. Thank you all for being here. May the Lord bless you. And thank you for those who support us in every way and every mean. I appreciate you all. I know you do not need my thank for your support. Those who download the videos, those who translate the videos, those who make donations. I really appreciate all of you. May the Lord bless you. And until we see you soon again, Christ is Lord. Islam is false. Thank you very much. Take care.